The undefeated Kansas Jayhawks will wear the title of favorites in their first nationally televised home game in 30 years. Rock chalk Jayhawk football style. Their quarterback, Chip Hillary, directs the highest scoring offense in Division 1A, more than 50 points a game. Meanwhile, Cal's Russell White will try to match Kansas big play for big play, the Bears and the Jayhawks.
Little Caesar's Pizza Pizza, where you always get two great pizzas for one low price.
And welcome back, Cal, Kansas, inspiring his troops in the final minutes before kickoff. Tuscaloosa, Alabama. Tide coach Gene Stallings has reinstated David Palmer for Alabama's game with Louisiana Tech this week. And he, of course, had been sitting out with a suspension since his second arrest for drunk driving. But Palmer is back for the Tide's game. Before we go to Cal and Kansas, guys, quick hitters.
Okay, Notre Dame-Purdue. Because of that tie with Notre Dame and Michigan, watch Lou Holtz to unleash Rick Meyer. They're behind in a national title race. Bad news for the Boilermakers. Good news for Rick Meyer.
Holtz should have done that with a minute five left in a particular ball game this year. Nebraska playing Arizona State. Arizona State will keep this game close against Washington. The first game of the year, they had 270 yards on the ground. Last week against Louisville, they held the Cardinals offense to 13 yards total offense, minus 78 yards rushing. Nebraska should win, but they definitely will play well against them.
The beleaguered Mighty Dog, a 1-2 start this season. We're going to go back to Georgia Tech. That breaks the tie. They're almost a touchdown underdog at home after the big pasting at Virginia. We like the Jackets to bounce back. Now, Cal, Kansas. Quick comment on the game we're about to
see. I thought Tulsa was going to beat Kansas. They beat them 40-7. I'm taking Kansas tonight. They proved to me.
Okay, Cal's got their work cut out for them. No doubt Kansas got that great defense and the top scoring offense in the country, so you really got to like their chances.
Russell White on one side, the highest scoring offense in the country. And do you see a lot of points? Is this a track meet tonight?
Well, I don't think it's a track meet unless Kansas makes it a track meet. I don't think California can keep up with them.
Jayhawks defense has been.
I agree with him for the first time this year.
It's historic. We'll all reassemble for the weekend kickoff show next week, and it'll be the halftime blitz at halftime. Stay tuned. Cal and Kansas coming up. Mike Patrick, Mike Gottfried, and Jerry Punch from Lawrence.
Thank you, Chris, and welcome to Memorial Stadium in Lawrence, Kansas, where the Golden Bears of California will take on the 24th ranked and undefeated Kansas Jayhawks. Good evening, everybody. I'm Mike Patrick. It's been a long time since Kansas football fans have had any reason to check the national polls every week. After all, it's been 7 years since they were listed by UPI and 17 years since they were ranked by the Associated Press. That's what makes this week so special. They are ranked 24. They are undefeated at 3-0, and they have the nation's highest scoring offense. They're talking about Jayhawk football here.
Not since 1976 has the Kansas Jayhawk football squad been ranked by the Associated Press.
KLDR, Lawrence.
He's going to throw! He's got the perfect touchdown! Whoa! What a play! A touchdown pass!
More honors are headed the Hawks' way.
Intercepted by Johnny Bowen! He runs to midfield! Johnny to the 40, down to the 30, to the 20! Johnny Bowen to the 10! Touchdown! Touchdown, Johnny Bowen!
I can even hear the enthusiasm in that guy's voice.
Here's the hole, the kick by Eichloff. It's got a chance. He got it. 61 yards. 61 yards.
Hello, everyone. I'm Jerry Punch at Fog Allen Fieldhouse, where Kansas basketball has hung four national championship banners. Glenn Mason's football program hasn't quite reached that level, but they have certainly given the Jayhawk faithful a fall sport to get excited about.
Fall was a downer for a long, long time.
We're not really used to winning a football game, so it's kind of exciting.
And I'm happy that it's going on while we're here. Yeah. Part of the tradition.
I'm skipping all my classes just for the game.
68 back again, maybe? I hope so.
Hi, I'm Mike Godfrey. The Kansas offense has received all the publicity, but if they're to beat Cal tonight, the Kansas defense must carry the load. Cal is led on offense by running back and Heisman candidate Russell White. And they also have a big play wide receiver in Sean Dawkins. Kansas has to find a way to neutralize them, then put pressure on sophomore quarterback Dave Barr and force him to beat Kansas. A big advantage for California may be the fact that they didn't play last week. Have 12 days to prepare for this game. Kansas had three practices to prepare for Cal. May be an edge for California.
And, Mike, they have also had 12 days to think about their shocking 41-14 loss at the hands of the Boilermakers of Purdue. Here comes Cal, and here come the Jayhawks. For the first time since 1986, Kansas with a chance to make an impression in front of a national TV audience. The kickoff in a moment. California comes into this ballgame 1-1. Kansas at 3-0 with the nation's highest scoring offense. Jayhawks coach Glenn Mason had this to say to his team just a few minutes ago.
Home, packed house, national TV. We got a hell of an opportunity. Hot damn, I'm proud of you guys. Now I want to just tell you something. You want to win, huh?
Yeah.
Man, I got to tell you. You don't wish, you don't hope, you don't sit back, you don't, you go take it.
Take it.
You line up, it's a big time shoot scrimmage, you understand that? You whip the man over you, that's what football's all about.
Woo!
It's a men, it's a game played by men, understand that?
Where we come
physical
from,
toughness comes on in here. Now, when all else fails, you play hard, you play hard, you play hard, and nothing else matters. And I've told you this a million times. No one wants to hear about the labor pains. All I want to do is see the
babies.
Let's deliver a good-looking baby tonight.
Glenn Mason has his team at 3-0. Wins over Oregon State, Ball State, and Tulsa. Tonight could be the test of how good they really are. First-year California coach Keith Gilbertson, 1-1. He has to wonder which team will show up, the one that ripped San Jose State or the one that was stunned by Purdue. Matt Eichloff will kick it off. Dan Eichloff will kick it off. Kansas won the toss, declined. California will receive as we start the first half. Chapman with the football on the return all the way across the 40-yard line. Eichloff had to make the tackle. And now for tonight's McDonald's starting lineups. The offense led by Heisman candidate Russell White, the number 5 rusher in the country. 147.5 yards a game, going for his third straight 1,000-yard season. Sean Dawkins, a terrific receiver. 17 career starts. He has 20 touchdown catches. Up front, Todd Stussy, one of only 2 starters back from a year ago. He's graded out higher than any other lineman in the first 2 games. A 37-yard kickoff return sets up Cal at its own 43. Russell White slips a tackle to the 48-yard line. That Kansas defensive line features Dana Stubblefield, the 285-pound senior, a Playboy preseason All-American. Linebacker Larry Thiel leads the team in tackles. His speed has helped him get 2 sacks and 3 other stops behind the line. Charlie Bowen, the veteran in the secondary, last week he returned an interception 63 yards for a touchdown. 2nd and 5. Barr hands it to White again. Good blocking across midfield to the Kansas 49. It'll be 3rd and 2. And obviously, Mike Gottfried, a big night for Russell White.
Well, it is. I talked to him yesterday on the field, Mike, and he said that he feels like he still has a Heisman chance, but he knows that he has to perform tonight. He said it's either going to be an A or an F. He said there's not going to be any in between. He said he has to try to out-duel Marshall Faulk.
He saw Faulk against BYU get 299 yards. 3rd and 2. Cal, opening possession of the game. White didn't make it. Mal Malanga made the stop, and Sylvester Wright also in there on the tackle. And this is a good defensive line.
The difference in this Kansas team and the teams before is that they have big defensive linemen. They control the line of scrimmage. They're a pressure defensive team.
Chris Noonan back to punt and deep to receive. Charlie Bowen waiting at his 10. Bowen signals for the fair catch up past the 15 and makes it there. 32-yard kick, no return. Look at the Kansas offense. Senior Chip Hillary, he'll quarterback. His total offense already over 800 yards and 6 touchdown passes. The receivers have shared the wealth so far. Tight end Dwayne Chandler averaging nearly 23 yards a catch. The only senior on a young offensive line, Keith Loniker. He was all Big 8 last year in a vote by the players. Maurice Douglas will open a tailback. They play four tailbacks in this system. Hillary with a long signal count. Douglas gets the first carry. Right in his face, linebacker Jarrett Willard, and then Barsala came over to make the tackle. California defense led by Mac Travis, the senior defensive tackle, the MVP of the Citrus Bowl last year. He's a Lombardi and Outland Trophy candidate. Sophomore linebacker Jarrett Willard off to a great start coming off the freshman All-American season. He leads the team in tackles. The Bears have a young secondary. Senior Wolf Barber is an excellent corner, also their best cover man. Hit at the line of scrimmage, and once again Willard is in on the tackle as he fights forward for a couple.
Mike, both these teams are mirror images of each other on offense and defense. Both play the eight-man front defense. You see the six people on the line of scrimmage and the two linebackers, and you see the linebackers come free. Number 13, Mark Barsala, and Jarrett Willard, number 45.
Go to a three wide receiver offense. Cousins is the single setback on third and eight. They really got a quick start. George White out on the flank just took off.
Mike, I think there's two quick factors here. One, Cal wanted to come out and get an edge right off the bat and start
dead
strong.
Ball. False start. Offense. Repeat third down. 5-yard penalty.
Kansas, there's been a lot of hype. ESPN, national TV. A little jittery from the start, so you've talked about jitters. Look at here. Oh, George, he's going to be a little embarrassed when they show up that back on the film.
George is thinking to himself, wait a minute, nobody else is moving. I'm 20 yards into the secondary.
Problem is they put the hook out on him and brought him to the sideline.
Third and 13. Hillary under pressure. Screen. Cousins, it was too low and he couldn't hold it. So neither team able to do much on offense. Opening series, both maybe a little tight.
Well, I think that Kansas a little tight from the start. Cal, you know, they had to sit for 12 days with that loss at Purdue, and they want to atone for that. They feel like it's important to come out and get a good start.
Dan Eichloff, into punt preseason All-American candidate, has a different punting style. He will stand left of center, then step to his right, and he holds the ball differently. Wolf Barber back to return, standing at his own 30. And Eichloff kicking with the wind. Different style. It's a big one out of there. Barber at the 40. Almost broke it. Did manage to get back to midfield. 11:23 to go, first period. We're scoreless. Kansas and California. ESPN's Thursday Night CFA is brought to you by Isuzu, makers of incredible four-wheel drive. And by Bud Dry. For a beer that's refreshingly different, try Bud Dry. Back in action, scoreless first quarter. California takes over at midfield. Barr hands it to White. Nice cutback. White at the 40. To the 20-yard line, dragged down by the ankles by Robert Vaughn, who saved a touchdown. And Russell White hot early.
Cal is running right at the defensive front of Kansas. He's looking in the eyes of a Heisman Trophy candidate, Russell White, as he makes the cutback. Now hits, really does a nice job setting up his block, and then will finally be tackled by Robert Vaughn, number 38. It's the cutback play that day against the pursuing defense that Russell White was able to break backside.
And running up the strength, the defensive tackle, Stubblefield and Mal Malanga. First and 10, Zomalt, the fullback, with the quick hitter struggling forward, gets near the 12-yard line.
It's easy to see what Cal's trying to do. They're going to try to pound at the defensive front, take a little pressure off of quarterback Dave Barr, put it in the hands of Russell White in the ground game early in the game. Mike Shepard, the offensive coordinator, was a coach for me here at Kansas, and I was the head coach of New Mexico, an outstanding offensive coach.
Second and five. One wide receiver, that's Sean Darkin. and they'll throw toward Dawkins. The ball tipped up in the air. It's picked off. Intercepted by the middle linebacker, Larry Thiel. The ground game works so well, and on second and five from the 12, they go to the pass and have it batted up.
May have been a checkoff against the eight-man front. And the ball was tipped, and that's what the gambling-type defense gives you. Number 96, Kyle Moore, tips the football. Larry Thiel picks it off, number 35, the first turnover of the game. And I think turnovers will determine this game because both teams are so aggressive on defense.
And that's the 11th turnover for the Kansas defense. They had 11 all last year. Douglas, the single setback. He'll get the carry. And there were five California defensive players beyond the line of scrimmage on that play. Cal really getting penetration.
You see Dave Barr on the sideline. Now, he knows he made a mistake. Ball was tipped. May have checked off to that play, but he knows his ground game's going. He just wants to get back on the field now. Has confidence in the early start.
Kansas unable to do anything on the ground so far. Monty Cousins, the single setback behind Hillary. And Cousins will get the carry. Mike, they keep trying inside the tackle against California without much success so far.
Both game plans are mirrored. Both teams are running at the inside. Now there's Artie Gigantino, the defensive coordinator. Now look for Kansas to eventually try to get Chip Hillary, the quarterback, outside the tackle box, either on a roll or a dash play where he sprints to the sideline to throw the football.
Hillary has rushed for 138 yards. This year, averaging like 8 yards a carry. Third and five. Cal showing that eight-man front, and here's Hillary checking off at the line again. They bring everybody. And Hillary overthrows LaCursey at midfield.
Mike, you're right. It's a checkoff against the Chicago Bear defense, the 46 defense. He, Chip Hillary, sees blitz coming all the way. Look at the defense. Look at the blitz coming. He knows he's got a one-on-one on the outside with number 81, Rob LaCursey. He just puts a little bit too much air under it. Wolf Barber's in pretty good coverage, but beat there, and the ball should have been completed.
Barber will now go back to receive the punt of Eichloff. Second team All-American punter, preseason All-American place kicker. Wobbly kick this time and short, but it takes a beautiful bounce for the Kansas Jayhawks. Inside the 25-yard line with the win. A 58-yard punt for Eichloff. Of course, Kansas in a building mode right now into the top 25, maybe 2-3 years behind what the California program has been able to do.
Well, Cal had the big year last year. You look at 1997, 4-1, and 1991, of course, 10-2, but beat a very fine Clemson team in the Citrus Bowl. But Bruce Snyder left the job, went to Arizona State. Keith Gilbertson now stepped in as a head man.
Cal with its worst field position, taking over at the 22. Looked like Barr called an audible. Wants to go to the quick out. Caldwell with the catch. He's wrapped up immediately by Gerald McBurrows, the sophomore corner.
What's interesting, I've been watching the wide tackle six and the eight-man front. They bait you. And just like in the Washington-Nebraska game the other night, they bait the quarterback. That's Bob Fellow, the defensive coordinator. They look like they're inside, grouped in to stop the run. As soon as you check off, they fly out to cover the pass.
Gain of only three on the last play.
This is Golden Pat Rule. The Golden Rule. The offensive coordinator talking to his offense. I think he'll open it up a little bit more in the next series, trying to get Chip Hillary involved with the option and roll out passing game.
We have 8:38 to go. First quarter. Kansas and California scoreless. This is the third possession for Cal. White again, straight up the middle, and again running room across the 30 to about the 31, a yard and a half shy of a first down. Sylvester Wright and Kwame Lassiter, the safety on the tackle.
Running right at Dennis Stubblefield, number 71, and the Todd Blackwell with a good block, number 70 for Cal. And this is a far different, more aggressive California team than played Purdue 12 days ago. They were lackluster at best, stood around and got clobbered. White again. He's got the first down up near the 35-yard line. And that must drive coaches crazy, Mike. You think you have a ball club that's going to go out and really do good things. And as they said, they just stood around.
Well, the players admitted when we talked to them the other day, they said, hey, we laid an egg. We were ready to play. Keith Gilbertson, who you see on the sideline, talked about how bad practice was the week of the Purdue game. But he feels like his team's going to bounce back. They're playing very aggressive on defense, trying to get the early edge.
Top 20 preseason team. They crushed San Jose State and then got leveled by Purdue. White tries to cut it outside. Not this time. Ronnie Ward, the freshman linebacker, wrapped him up.
Mike, the defenses, the eight-man front defenses, they kind of feed off of turnovers, lost yardage, sacks. And here you see the eight-man front, and watch the penetration. You're going to have to be able to try to get the ball outside, but not this way. Redirection sometimes just takes too long. Ronnie Ward sitting outside there with no one blocking him, making a tackle.
White already with 53 yards on 7 carries here in the first quarter. Comes the big rush. They've got Barr at the 34-yard line. And it was middle linebacker Larry Thiel who already has an interception. Now he gets a sack.
Larry Thiel, Kansas had a blitz on. The number 35, Larry Thiel, you see him on the inside. He's got the back. He just sits there and waits for the quarterback, Dave Barr, to take off with the football, and he makes the tackle.
This is the number 2 defense in the nation. They have given up only 187 yards a game. Only 103 on the ground. White already has half that total. Barr floats it down the middle, and it's complete inside the 30 to the 25. Sean Dawkins. 6'4", 205. He's one of the premier receivers in the country.
Mike, a great call by Mike Shepard. What he did is he put his great receiver, Sean Dawkins, number 86, on the backside. It gets him in a man-to-man situation versus Robert Vaughn. He brought all 3 receivers to the other side, which would guarantee him the one-on-one. Dave Barr now, big confidence builder for him with the long pass to Sean Dawkins.
Gain of 40 yards. Vaughn got there, just couldn't knock it away. White on the sweep. Excuse me, Chapman in a tailback, giving White a breather. He's down to the 22. Lassiter helped take him out of bounds, along with Gerald McBurrows. Chapman, a junior, 5'9", 190.
Two players that Kansas must take away. Russell White on the long runs, but Sean Dawkins, number 86, is the big play wide receiver. They're going to get caught in some one-on-one situations, and that's where Dave Barr has to be able to deliver the football to Sean Dawkins.
Dawkins with 20 career touchdowns, only 2 away from Wesley Walker, and he's a junior. Zomalt, the fullback, gaping hole up the middle, and he spins his way to the 12-yard line.
Boy, an impressive play by California. Greg Zomalt, number 28. It's just a quick hitting dive. But what Kansas likes to do with their 4-man front, you see them, the defensive lineman up the field. They get so far up the field that the fullback, Greg Zomalt, number 28, is able to break the quick hitting play.
It's almost like blocking on draw play. You just let him go.
Let him come on inside, but make sure you get the block on number 35, Larry Field.
First down, Cal. The last time they were down here, they had a pass batted in the air and intercepted. Barr to throw again. Dawkins inside the 5 at the 3-yard line. Gerald McBurrows makes the stop.
Single coverage again. Because of the formation, they have to single. Look at the coverage and look at the cushion that Sean Dawkins receives here off of Gerald McBurrows, number 3. Not going to be able to stop that play with that cushion.
A nice throw by Barr, too.
He's gaining confidence as he goes along. He had that interception. He's able to come back and complete 2 passes.
Third team a year ago. Look at this drive. Covered at their own 22-yard line. Russell White back in for the end zone. Touchdown.
Mike, I'm going to repeat myself again, but it was very important for Keith Gilbertson's team. and Russell White and this entire offense and defense can get off to a good start. They're not sure how good they are. They lost some confidence at Purdue. Mike Shepard talked to his offensive line about staying pad under pad, getting low on the offensive line. You see how low they're trying to get underneath the defensive front of Kansas. Good, solid drive.
Doug Bryan is on to try the point after another tremendous place kicker. And he knocks his sixth point after straight through. And Cal has taken a 7-point lead in this game over 24th-ranked Kansas. And Russell White has had a big first period. 7-0, the Golden Bears of California lead the undefeated Kansas Jayhawks in the first quarter. Nice effort by Russell White in the first period. The scoring drive, 78 yards, took nearly 5 minutes off the clock, and White finished it off for the 7-0 California lead. Yards, first quarter rushing Russell White. That works out to a little over 200.
He's going after the teacher's grade now.
A or F, says yeah. Mike Godfrey. He usually gets an A. Didn't get many yards against Purdue, but he didn't get a chance. They fell behind so quickly, they had to throw the ball.
Keith Gilbertson said we tore the tailback plays out of the play, but we were behind so far, we had to throw the football. So Russell wasn't a factor.
Charlie Bowen and George White deep to receive Doug Bryan's kick. 8 of 12 coming in had gone for touchbacks for Bryan, but he'll be kicking into the wind here in the first quarter. How long has it been since they played a night game at Memorial Stadium? Well, we weren't here. It was 1931.
I wonder what they did with the lights.
Yeah. Could have been torches in 31. Bryan, a high floating kick. Bowen from the 5. Seam right up the middle. Bowen out to the 36-yard line. Taken down by Wolf Barber. ESPN, your home every Saturday for the best in college football. Starting at 11:30, our college game day crew, Chris Fowler, Lee Corso, and Craig James will bring you up to date on what will happen the entire day. Then at 12:30, we'll go off to Bloomington as the Missouri Tigers take on the Hoosiers of Indiana. And we'll be back at 7 o'clock with the Residence Inn Scoreboard Show. All the scores and highlights from all over the country. Then at 7:30, our CFA primetime matchup, Clemson against Georgia Tech. Cal was offside on the kickoff. Kansas with a good return will decline. We have a split crew between the Big 8 and the Pac-10 tonight.
Split crew, I always worried about the umpire. I always want the umpire on my side.
He is a Pac-10 official tonight. Hillary, delay to Douglas. Much.
Always nice when you see the referee's split crew. You always like to see your own guys. Bob Fellow, the defensive coordinator of Kansas, just going over the last series, what was happening on the field, see how calm and cool and collective he is at this point.
Outside.
Motor turned inside.
Second and 8, they'll go back to the eye. Cousins and Douglas to beat me. Option. Hillary has room. First down and more to the 40 and stepped out of bounds. He was out of bounds, it looked like, about 5 yards before he slowed up. That's why he just sort of pulled off.
This is where Kansas has to have success, getting Chip Hillary outside in the option. Block of the offensive guard. Now you see the wide receiver blocking downfield. Chip Hillary with good yardage just kind of ran out of bounds. Watch Jared Willard, number 45. He's in pretty good shape because he's got the quarterback, but once he sidestepped that block, he was dead.
First down, Kansas at the 35, a gain of 27 for Hillary. Now he's back to throw. Little sprint out. On the run to the sideline and too high for Rob LaCursey. Kansas has had so much fun on offense so far. They have averaged 50.3 points a game. That's first in the country. Averaging 490 yards a game. That is fourth best. And in the top 20 in both rushing and passing yards. And Mike, you can tell how dangerous they are when Hillary is able to get outside and make something happen.
Well, it's interesting when you have your quarterback roll out. He's going to take some hits if Kansas uses it in the option in the rollout passing game.
Cousins will take it straight back up the middle. They have had very, very little success between the tackles so far tonight. Mark it at the 32. It's a little funny to take a look at Kansas because nobody's statistics jump out at you, and yet they're averaging all these yards and all these points. What's going on?
I think the key is Chip Hillary. He's a gunslinger, a gunfighter type of quarterback. Just a very solid competitor.
He has missed all three passes so far and faces third and seven here. Four-man rush. And Hillary is sacked anyway with a four-man pressure brought down at the 40-yard line. Cal did it with four guys pushed straight up the middle. Scott Roseman, who had four sacks a year ago in the first five games before he hurt his ankle, will get credit for that sack, his second of the season. And Roseman, a real small defensive lineman at 235.
It's not a good sign for Kansas. When you get pressure out of the front four, then that allows you not to have to blitz your linebackers.
Eichloff on fourth and 15 will come into punt. Now keep in mind, here's a young man who hit a 61-yard field goal earlier. They would have to try about 57 from here, but they will have the punting unit on instead, and now maybe they're going to think about it.
I think they're going to get a delay of game. Unless they get, no, they're going to get to delay a game.
Offense, hang on us.
You can just tell they're a little nervous from the start. And again, you take the hype and being on TV for the first time. They have just reacted just a little bit jittery here in the early going. They'll settle down.
So Eichloff, no question about a possible field goal now.
And that penalty doesn't hurt you because it gives you five more yards to try to punt it inside the 20-yard line.
Tyrone Edwards and Wolf Barber back as double safeties. And Eichloff just kicks it straight up in the air. Barber will come all the way out to the 23 to make the fair catch. Cal will start from there when we come back. The Bears lead by seven.
It's a Davis Cup dream team. Courier, Agassi, Sampras, and McEnroe take on Sweden. You've got to see them to believe them. Saturday and Sunday on ESPN. It's back. Back where it belongs. The NHL returns to ESPN when the Stanley Cup champion Penguins face Eric Lindros and the Flyers. Tuesday, October 6th, live on ESPN.
Campanile Bell Tower overlooking this field. That's Campanile Hill. They can get 5,000 people to get to watch for free. They want to get them in here, so they're spending money on Kansas football. Cal takes over, whistles, will stop this play. And Russell White brought down for a loss of five. Let's check out what the officials had in mind. Kyle Moore made the stop.
Boy, Keith Gilbertson just threw his headset off on the sidelines. Really irate about something.
People have been talking about this all week, and I think you made an excellent point. Neither one of these teams really sure how good they are yet.
No, Kansas is not sure.
We're going to replay the down, please. Put 124 on the clock. 124 on the clock, please.
I think what was happening, first of all, let me just say, I think the official was talking to Keith Gilbertson, and they ran the play. So now they got to go back and run the play again, put the time back on the clock. But what I was saying, Mike, is that Kansas is not sure how good they are. They've had three blowout wins, but everybody keeps saying, well, you know, have they beaten a good football team? I think they have, but they still don't know. Cal, on the other hand, is coming off that embarrassing loss, and they're not sure whether it's a San Jose effort or the Purdue effort, which team is which. And
let's check in with Jerry Punch right now. Doctor?
guys on the Kansas sidelines, both the offensive and defensive coordinators are just simply trying to settle their ball players down. Kansas offensive coordinator Golden Pat Rule a minute ago said, guys, we're going to go back to basics. Simple toss sweep, simple dive belly pattern. We're getting a little too excited early in the game. Let's go back to basics. Let's dance with the girl that got us here. Our basic offensive front, and move the ball down the field. We'll see if they do it next time they have the ball on offense. Back upstairs.
All right, Jerry, thanks. And now I think they're trying to explain to both coaches what happened on that last play. And of course, California lost 5 yards as the play was run, and Kansas would like to get that, but they're not going to.
That's a good thing about a split crew too. You can always send the guy's friend. You're the Pac-10 guy, you go over and explain it to him. You're the Big 8 guy, you go over and tell Glenn Mason we're playing this move.
So now they've reset the clock to 1:24 to go in the quarter. They'll spot it near the 25, and it's first and 10 again. White and Zoma are the backs behind Barr. And it looked like Kansas jumped offside. Now Malanga got an early start and put his hand out on one of the down linemen.
Some of the tapes I've seen, Chris Malmalonga has jumped offside in games before. And now Dave Barr's using a command there. You see the little sharp move he makes with his helmet and draw the offside. So now, how about this for a break? Instead of being losing five on a down,
yeah,
you get it back. Now you gain five, change 10 yards, and now we start first down again.
Instead of second and 15, it's first and five at the 30.
Good trade-off for Cal, bad one for Kansas.
The fullback, and he'll be wrapped up at the line of scrimmage. Zoma can't get by Hassan Bailey, who's one of the smaller linebackers around at 205 pounds.
It's interesting what Cal did on this play. Dave Barr came up and made this call right away. Because Kansas moves on defense, he didn't want to give him a chance to move. He just ran the play. And Greg Zoma, again, tried to break backside. There's just no blocking there. Hassan Bailey, number 7 from Gahanna, Ohio, makes the tackle.
So second and 5 now. Kansas shows they're coming again, and Russell White gets a couple and no more. Swarmed over by the Jayhawk defense. Dan Davis, number 39, led the wave. And Kyle Moore, 96, the last up off the pile.
Larry Thiel really made that play because he blitzed and got inside and made some penetration, but still couldn't bring Russell White down. He still was able to get back to the line of scrimmage.
And Mike, one of the reasons that Cal has had such success up the middle is that those linebackers are moving around. Third and 3. White on the toss. Dives toward the first down stick. It depends on the mark. Needed to get within a football of the 35, and it will be very close. And it is a first down. And they'll wind the clock, and that will be the end of the first quarter. And Heisman candidate Russell White has strutted his stuff in the first period, and California has a 7-0 lead over undefeated Kansas.
If you want a beer that drinks easy like a light and has real draft taste, why not make a change for the better? Refreshingly different, but dry. Bud Dry is one beer that drinks easy like a light and has real draft taste. So why not come around to something refreshingly different? Try Bud Dry.
Set to start the second quarter from Memorial Stadium in Lawrence, Kansas. And California with a 7-0 lead and the football from their own 35, first and 10. White gets a breather, and Lindsey Chapman, the deep man in the eye. And Barr with a pump fake floats it for Dawkins. He's got it again. Dawkins out of bounds at the 33-yard line. There is a penalty flag down back at the 30. And it will come back. Boy, Dawkins just looks like a gazelle out there.
That 6'4 frame and 205 pounds. He runs an out route. Looks like he's going to run an out. Spins, now takes off. Gets behind Gerald McBurrows. And then number 22, Charlie Bowen, just can't come up with the play. He's just too far off. And it's just a good throw by Dave Barr.
Well, that's a pretty pattern, too.
Tough to lose those big plays like that, because here's the guy that Kansas has to stop, Sean Dawkins. They're going to get enough of Russell White. He's going to get the ball in the hands, but they cannot allow this guy to get big plays, Sean Dawkins.
White is back in. Of course, if you're playing an eight-man front, it's almost impossible to double cover somebody. First and 22 as they mark off the penalty from the spot of the foul. White back in. He'll get the carry. And White lumbers his way up to about the 29-yard line. Now Malanga chased him down from his tackle spot along with Don Davis, the linebacker. Harry Klein on the sideline, who lost the battle for the number one quarterback job with Dave Barr. Keith Gilbertson told us he will play both quarterbacks, and we expected Klein to be in at the start of the second quarter. Right now, very difficult to take Barr out. He's played beautiful. Second and 16. Barr straight back. Hit just as he throws, overthrown and intercepted. Robert Vaughn back to midfield, trying to pick up a block. And Vaughn down to the California 44. And it was Russell White who nailed it. Barr hit just as he threw.
From the left side of your screen, you're going to see Danis Stubblefield, number 71, with pressure, and then Hassan Bailey also. But they caused the interception. They caused the errant throw. Now, after the ball is intercepted by Robert Vaughn, he changes directions, but you're going to find Russell White, the All-American tailback, number 4, is just sitting back waiting on him and makes the tackle.
Big break for Kansas. Let's see if they can convert. Douglas down to the 41-yard line on the toss sweep.
It went to an unbalanced line, Mike, to get an extra blocker against the eight-man front. Tyrone Edwards, number 9, the free safety, who was a former running back, made the tackle.
Barr now with two interceptions, one that was tipped, another one that sailed long after he was hit just as he threw.
Turnovers are going to determine this football game because of the pressure defenses.
Cousins, the up back, Douglas to beat him. Picks his way forward with a 41-yard line. Gain maybe one.
These defenses, the way they play, force the quarterbacks to make decisions. They force them to check to different plays. Now, Chip Hillary made a check there and checked off to the running game. The success they had. Remember the option play that they ran. They
right.
Looked for Kansas to come back with Chip Hillary on the corner.
Third and 7 here. Kansas has done so much with the turnovers. 11 takeaways, 38 points off of them. Hillary changing the play again.
Checking off the pass.
Here comes the blitz. Hangs in there and throws incomplete. Intended for George White out of the backfield, and Hillary was ripped as he unloaded it.
The other thing Cal wanted to accomplish tonight, they wanted to tag Chip Hiller. They wanted to belt him, and they're blitzing. They're coming after him. They're trying to hit him on the option. Watch the pressure again from the eight-man front. Come up inside. Number 43, Scott Roseman, 6'4", 235, gets the hit on Chip Hiller.
Roseman had the sack earlier. Barber and Edwards are back deep for Eichloff's punt. A little more room to work with. Kicks this one away. A flag is down, and it will go into the end zone, does it? It does.
Now, Mike, this brings up an interesting point. I think this is offside on Cal. If it is, now do you kick the field goal? Do you move it 5 yards closer? Kansas may have a chance to put points on the board.
Or do you go for it?
Defense.
Would bring up 4th and 2.
It's going to be an interesting decision for Glenn Mason, but that 5 yards may have cost Cal.
They would be kicking into about a 10-12 mile an hour wind.
Looks like they're going for it.
I clock, both the punter and the place kicker. And right now he's at the sideline, and Kansas will come out on fourth and two to go for it. You got to like this.
I think this is a good move by Kansas because their defense is playing well.
And they need something to get the crowd back in it.
Chip Hillary on an option or a rollout pass.
Full house backfield. Chapman on the toss. No place to go. Buried at the 36-yard line. Wolf Barber up from the secondary along with Eric Zomal.
Kansas went to a real tight formation to run the toss sweep, figuring they'd get the extra body, the extra motion man on that outside backer. The Wolf Barber, number 8, just flies up, avoided the block, and was able to make the tackle.
So Kansas goes for it on 4th and 2 and comes up short.
One company in America, Chrysler, has found a new way to develop cars. Instead of designers, engineers, manufacturers, and parts suppliers all working separately, they found a way to work as one in something called a platform team.
The result? A new kind of architecture
for the automobile. It's called cab forward. The first thing we did was move the windshield dramatically forward. Then we pulled the rear wheels back. This gives you more room inside. We gave it a wider track to help provide more stability and
safer handling. Then we incorporated every advanced feature you could
possibly want. From dual airbags to four-wheel anti-lock
brakes. But enough nuts and bolts. Don't you want to see what these cars look like?
Introducing the Chrysler Concorde, the Dodge Intrepid, and the Eagle Vision. Cars that will define automotive design into the next century. In the car business you lead, follow. Get out of the way.
ESPN's Thursday Night CFA is brought to you by Chrysler Corporation and your local Chrysler Plymouth, Dodge, Jeep, and Eagle dealers. And by AC Delco Automotive Parts. AC Delco, it's like buying time. Mike Patrick, Mike Gottfried, and Dr. Jerry Ponch with you from Lawrence, Kansas, where the undefeated Jayhawks are trailing California 7-0. 12:23 to go first half. Cal takes over at its own 36 after holding on 4th and 2. White gets the carry. Wrapped up this time around the ankles, Hassan Bailey, number 7, with the stop. Back to that last play where they went for it on 4th and 2, Coach.
Just look at the alignment of the defense on the last play. You can count all 11 California defensive players and all 11 Kansas players. They're playing in the living room, in the phone booth right now. And that's why Cal is able to avoid the block and make the play.
2nd and 8. White, 67 yards on 12 carries. He's got it again, and he'll lose 3. Ronnie Ward, number 46, with a big first half. Here's a pennant update for you. Blue Jays jumping all over the Orioles in the second inning. Expos leading the Pirates, 4th. And Russell White will come to the sideline on 3rd and 10 as they'll go to their wide receiver package. The blitz, has time, throws complete to Caldwell. He's got a first down at the 47-yard line. Gerald McBurrows made the tackle.
That's the second time now Cal has been able to go to 3 receivers to one side, put a single receiver, you see him to the backside. Mike Caldwell, number 82, gets one-on-one coverage, knows where the stake is, curls up in front of number 3, Gerald McBurrows, for the first down.
And they isolated Caldwell out there because he's an excellent possession receiver. He's caught a pass in 27 straight games. Chapman, the tailback, on the draw. And Kansas getting more penetration on defense again. Hassan Bailey, number 7, makes the tackle.
Mike, Keith Gilbertson believes in the two quarterback system because he worked for Don James. Don James, of course, has Billy Joe Hobert, Mark Brunell. And he feels like you have to train the quarterback in game situations. So that's why he wants to get Perry Klein in the game. But the way this game's going, I don't know if Perry Klein's going to see the field in the first half.
Of course, after the second interception, you thought you would see Klein warming up, but not so far. Second and 11 for the Golden Bears. Far, five men coming after him. Dawkins caught it inbounds at the 18-yard line. Once again, Gerald McCarles on the coverage, and he was right there, but looked like he missed the ball.
Kansas was going to pressure. Cal brought the receivers in. They only have two receivers out in this route. Watch Sean Dawkins just run by Gerald McBurrows. Now let's see if he catches it in bounds. Yes, pretty good catch, but it's put down. Good game. But they're bringing extra, they're bringing their other receivers in to block, and really they only have two receivers out.
Dawkins, three catches, 87 yards. And how do you keep covering Dawkins man-to-man? We'll ask Mike Gottfried that in a second. Zomal got to the 15-yard line and was drilled at that point. Charlie Bowen nailed him.
Well, the reason you're playing man-to-man on Sean Dawkins is because number four is out there, Russell White. So your eight-man front is designed to stop the run, but also to disguise. And they'll get some help on Sean Dawkins, but in the plays that when they do go one-on-one, number 16, Dave Barr has to see that. Check out, take advantage of the one-on-one situations.
Second and seven, White will leave the ball game. Holly is the single setback, and Barr trying to get it off. Throws in the end zone, intended for Dawkins, too high, covered by McBurrows.
Had him again, had him in man situation again. He knows every time he looks out there and he gets man-to-man, he's going to 86. Sean Dawkins on the post, just a little too high, but I'm not so sure he couldn't have got his hands up and got that one.
And McBurrows at 5'11", giving away 5 inches to Dawkins.
Well, every time he looks out there and sees him one-on-one, he's going to throw the football to him because his percentages are pretty good.
Yeah.
He's got a 6'4" receiver, can run.
And Cal will take a timeout with 9:18 to go in the half. Dave Barr wants to come over and talk with Keith Gilbertson on third and seven.
Georgia Tech's Sean Jones faces a tough and determined Clemson defense. Saturday night, live on ESPN.
It isn't the night or even the fog that gets you. It's when the team leader puts you in charge for the first time. And you decide to drop right inside Alpha Team's backyard. That's when you find out how good you really are.
Seven nothing, California over Kansas, 9:18 to go first half. And now for tonight's U.S. Army student of the game. He's California junior place kicker Doug Bryan, a political economy major with a 3.2 grade point average. The Kansas defense came into this ball game allowing 187 yards a game, number two in the country. How much have they given up so far? 187 yards.
So California understands this defense, so they understand how to attack it.
Throw, floats it in the end zone, intended for Dawkins. Beautiful coverage that time by McBurrows, who had the pattern figured, and Barr was nailed again.
We talked about one-on-one coverage on Sean Dawkins. Now look, he's going to get some help from number 22. No, Bowen breaks away, but he's playing a little bit more of a zone outside coverage. Gerald McBurrows, number three, in better shape to stop the corner route.
Doug Bryan will come on to try the field goal and watch Barr as he gets nailed at the end of this one. It will be a 33-yard field goal attempt. Bryan is perfect this year and still is. And that raises the lead to 10-0. And 45,000 people are extremely quiet here at Memorial Stadium.
When I talked to Keith Gilbertson and Mike Shepard about the offense, they said, we're coming in here and we have design plays to block eight in the run game and to pick up the eight-man blitz. We've cut back our offense. So they've come in here with a short list of plays and figure that execution of what the limited things are going to do will carry them.
Our CFA Thursday night series will continue next week as Chris Fowler, Lee Corso, and Craig James will preview your college football weekend games. That's at 7:45 Eastern with a weekend kickoff show. Then we'll be in Starkville, Mississippi as the 13th-ranked Gators meet the Bulldogs of Mississippi State in an SEC showdown. He's right here. He's traveling all over the country. Gets to go home about, what, one day a week?
Yeah, and I've got a cold right now. I'm trying to use my Mike Patrick, Ron Franklin voice tonight.
He's everywhere we go. A lot of people show up, want to see how Mike's doing, check in with him. Everybody enjoys his work, as we do.
I appreciate that, Mike. Good people here in Lawrence, Kansas. Enjoyed it here. Plus, that guy who wrote the sign there, I had to give him some money for the game.
Had $10. Bowen lets it sail. That's a live ball. Now it's whistled dead by the official as it hits into the end zone. We want to talk about big wins in Jayhawk football history. Let's go back to October 27, 1984. Kansas, coached by a second-year youngster, Mike Gottfried, stunned Barry Switzer and second-ranked Oklahoma 28-11. Mike would coach Kansas State for three seasons, left Lawrence with a record of 15-18-1. That was the best mark at Kansas of any coach since 1970. Good picture of you, huh? Hillary with room to run, and that has been the most successful offensive play that Kansas has had. They ran the option. Hillary gained 20. That time he had a nice hole up the middle.
He runs the ball well, and the option is the play that's best suited for him. And they get him on the corner, but he was didn't see any receiver, just tucked it up. And when you play the eight-man front, they're going to get people up the field, so they create some running lanes for the quarterback.
Gain of 9, second and 1. Cousins, man, he's got the first down. Why do you think, Mike, with the success of the one-option play that they ran, they have not run it again?
I think they're seeing something defensively that they feel like that they can run inside. And if they can open it up inside, then that'll open the option up more for them. But I figure that they've got to run the option here in the next couple plays because of the success they had on the first down.
It's only the second first down for Kansas in this ballgame. Receiver set, and they want a screen, and it's knocked down. Hillary just sort of dumped it in the face of Brad Bowers, number 99, and he just slapped it down to the ground.
Well, the way that front four is really charging Brad Bowers, number 99. Now remember, he's 6'7", and you always tell your defensive lineman, get your hands up as soon as you see the pass. Get your hands up, knock the ball back on the screen. And they may have had a play because of the pressure that Cal's defensive front was putting on.
Bowers out of San Jose, and we have an injured player. It's Mac Travis, who has been banged up throughout fall practice. Not serious injuries, just things that have slowed him down all year. He is both an Outland and a Lombardi Award candidate, and actually said he'd be disappointed if he didn't win one or both. Let's check in with Jerry Punch. Jerry? We'll check in with Jerry in just a second as Travis is assisted off the field. Second and 10. Hillary under pressure again. Throws complete up at the 47-yard line. Got it to Matt Gay. And he's wrapped up by Ike Booth, who's in there for the injured Chris Cannon.
Well, it's the same thing on the other side of the field, because you're going to get one-on-one coverage when you're blitzing. If you're California, Matt Gay, number 5, against Ike Booth, number 26. Randy out, pitch and catch.
And the first completion for Hillary. He had missed his first 5. Kansas looking a little looser on offense and defense. Nice play action by Hillary. Again, Gay inside the 30. Booth shoved him out of bounds. A little more spark from this team right now. I don't think they were flat, but I think they were scared.
I think they were nervous, and now they've settled in. Matt Gay and Chip Hillary, they caught
California in two deep coverage. You see the coverage on Matt Gay. Now Chip Hillary makes this play because he threads the needle in between the two defenders. The flat route and then number 26, Ike Booth. Good route, good throw by Chip Hillary.
And Booth just got enough. He was the last man in the secondary. 7:45 to go first half. Kansas undefeated, trailing 10-0, trying to come alive on offense. Hillary, nice play fake. Room to run. 10-5, touchdown. A lot more bounce in that Kansas offense on that series.
Well, the play fake from Chip Hillary makes this play, and he's dangerous when you get him outside. There's no contain. California lost contain. Number 32, Michael Davis, got sucked inside on the fake, and that opened it up for Chip Hillary.
28-yard run for a touchdown, and Eichloff on for the point after. He's got it. And Kansas has cut the lead to 3. Chip Hillary, the senior quarterback from Westerville, Ohio, rushed for 37 yards on that drive and passed for 39. A drive of 80 yards and a touchdown.
About money, I don't. Swear to God, it's not the issue. I just want to win. I want that ring. My dad's never had the opportunity to get that ring, and I want that ring.
Football without end is in your face on ESPN. Saturday, it's college games galore.
Sunday, it's NFL game day.
NFL primetime.
On ESPN, great football without end is...
in your face.
In your face.
They are throwing oranges at Memorial Stadium, hoping that this will be the team that will go to the Orange Bowl. We're just glad they're not shooting for the Gator Bowl right now.
Mike, I'll tell you, tough loss. Mack Travis got hurt, and he's the leader of that defense. Kansas took advantage and was able to get that score.
After that very nervous first quarter, that has to be a huge boost for the Jayhawks.
They'll settle in now.
80-yard drive. Hillary finished it off from 28 yards out and made 3 excellent play fakes in that last series.
Grandma.
Travis, their best defensive lineman on the sideline, being worked on. 290-pound junior. And they'll try to get him back in the ball game. Russell White and Lindsey Chapman wait at the 10 for Eichloff's kickoff. And he crushed this one into the wind, and he knocked it out of the end zone. Hope you'll be with us at noon Eastern for NFL game day on Sunday. Chris Berman and company provide previews, features, analysis of all the day's games. Then at 7 o'clock, we'll be back with primetime, where you'll see all the highlights of every game. Barr remains in at quarterback, so the initial plan of using Perry Klein in the second quarter has not come to fruition yet. White and Zomalt are the backs. Dawkins to the top of the screen, and Russell White will get the carry. Spun off one tackle, but only gets 3 yards out of it. Chris Malmalonga got the first contact and brought him down.
Russell White is going to have to earn every yard tonight because he's getting hit in the backfield with this 8-man front.
Malmalonga said the first time he ever saw snow was when he came here on a recruiting visit, a young man who was deeply involved with LA gangs and has literally resurrected his life. Family member shot, friend shot, and he said he came close to it. Now he tries to go back and tell him, hey, you got a chance. Here's White getting outside, but the Kansas defense swarms on him and brings him down at the 29-yard line. Davis was in on the stop along with Charlie Bowen, and he knows Russell White. He said, playing high school football in California, he said everybody kept saying he's the man. He says, I'm sick of it. I want him to earn everything he gets tonight.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's earning everything he's getting. And I'll tell you, I'm impressed with Russell White in this first half. He's earning some tough yards.
75 yards on 15 carries, third and one. Zomalt, the fullback, second effort, may have gotten it. He was initially stopped at the 29 and then dove forward and has the first down. We're at Memorial Stadium in Lawrence, Kansas. The storyline, White 75 yards in the first half. Barr has had over 100 yards passing. Hillary with 56 yards rushing for Kansas as they are trailing for the first time this year. Three wide receiver set. Barr has the completion to Caldwell. Caldwell will have another first down out at the 42.
Good decision by Dave Barr again. Blitz was on, eight-man front. One-on-one coverage. You got three receivers to the field. Pitch and catch with Mike Caldwell, number 82. You know, you live by the blitz, you die by the blitz sometimes. But they forced two turnovers already on defense. But Dave Barr looks to me like he's making good decisions.
Barr has the two interceptions, but he's 6 out of 10 for 113 yards. Both teams opening up their offense. Simeon on the flanker screen, and that goes nowhere. Kansas did it beautifully. Don Davis, number 39, the linebacker, right on top of Simeon as soon as he caught it.
This offense is the national offense right now, started by Dennis Erickson, the one back. But you see the three receivers. Number two, Damian Simeon, comes back in on the screen, but Kansas just reacts too quickly. Don Davis, number 39, makes the tackle.
White and Zomalt back in as the running backs in the second and 10. And here's the yardage story so far. California already exceeding what Kansas averages on defense. Barr with plenty of time. Throws to his tight end. Stafford has a first down. Stafford with his seventh catch of the year, and Thiel and Davis, the linebackers, had to make the catch.
Now you look at Kansas on defense, and they say, well, maybe we shouldn't blitz. Let's go to a four-man rush. Now the four-man rush doesn't get to Dave Barr, so he has more time to look for Steve Stafford, number 89, the tight end, if he comes open. He just moved away from Larry Thiel, number 35, for the completion.
4 minutes, 39 seconds to go. Rapidly moving first half. Cal up by three. Zomalt, the fullback, another big gaping hole up the middle down to the 34-yard line. Close to another first down.
Boy, Mike Shepard, the offensive coordinator, just keeps pushing the right buttons because that's a trap play. You invite the defensive line, they're roaring up the field. Bob Fellow defensively trapped him and got a good game.
187 yards a game is second in the nation. Cal already has 222. And we told you at the beginning of the game, Cal, a preseason top 20 team, really let down against Purdue, but much better than they showed in that one, and they're out to prove it tonight. Second and a yard. White stumbling forward near the first down marker at the 33. Russell White, we talked about Mal Malanga coming from tough circumstance. Differently, Russell White, because he was a Prop 48 student at Cal, a school with such a tremendous academic reputation, caught a lot of flack, as did the athletic department, when he was recruited as a running back. Had to sit out his first year. He said he felt he was walking around with a stupid stencil on his forehead, and then they found out he had dyslexia, the learning disability, and you wonder how he could go through 12 years of school without somebody finding out he had dyslexia. It happens too often to too many kids. He has become a fine student as well as a Heisman candidate.
Mike, that Prop 48 thing's all wrong because it does stamp the guy, but Russell White and so many guys that go to schools around the country prove it wrong, and you have to take your hat off to Russell White. He's making a great example.
And he already has it written down. May 23rd, 9 a.m. He will graduate in 4 years. Here's the blitz on Barr. Still has time. Wants the screen and throws, and nobody there but his lineman. Hassan Bailey was in the face of Dave Barr.
Well, they went to man coverage, and what happened to Dave Barr was you're going to see the screen. You see the pressure, but the linebackers dropped off to play the screen. Dave Barr just threw the ball away. Now, if you count, you have to be thinking, number 86.
Second and 10. And Dawkins comes to the near side, the flank of the right, Semien. They run another screen. This is Chapman blocking in front. And Kansas played that very, very well. Could have gone for the big gain, and Robert Vaughn, number 38, makes the tackle.
Well, it was a crack screen, and Sean Dawkins, you're going to see number 86, not only does he catch the football, but he's going to crack back blocker here. Comes in, and there's the block on number 7, Hassan Bailey, but that's why he's at 6'4 frame. So not only catches the ball, but also is a good blocker. Here's another look. Watch him come inside, seal off on the screen.
Third and 4 from the 27. Blitz again. Barr unloads. Complete to Zoma, but he'll be shy of the first down. Hit in his tracks. Charlie Bowen, the safety, was right there as Zoma came out of the backfield to make the catch. Don Davis once again in on Barr, forcing him to throw the little check down. And Brian will come on to try the field goal. They'll spot it at the 35, so it's a 45-yard attempt. He's already connected from 33 and is perfect this year. High snap, but they got it down, and Brian's kick is good. Doug Brian, 7-for-7 this year, and Cal extends its lead to 6, 13-7 over Kansas, 2:06 to go in the first half.
At Thrifty Car Rental, we understand how therapeutic vacations can be. Getting away from the little power plays. Reassessing your personal goals. So to help make your vacation a relaxing one, when you're shopping for a rental car, call Thrifty and rent a full-size four-door like the new Chrysler Concorde. Just $34.95 a day.
When I need a car, I always rent from Thrifty. So remember, when it's your money, call 1-800-4-CARS.
Memorial Stadium at Kansas, California, with a pair of field goals and a touchdown, leading by 6 over undefeated Kansas. 2:06 to go in the half. Brian, who is now 7-for-7 this year, finished that drive with a 45-yard field goal with the win. And Kansas, in the last 2:06, will be going against the win. Cal has spent most of its night in Kansas territory. Charlie Bowen and George White deep to receive. And Bowen will let this one go out of the end zone. Let's check in with Jerry Punch. Doctor, what do you have?
Guys, senior defensive tackle Mac Travis of California has been hampered by injury since the spring. Now, he injured his left knee back in the spring. It's a mild sprain. He's also been hobbled 5 days ago with a foot injury. But a moment ago, he came off the field. They were looking at his right knee. I spoke to Dr. John McShane, who said, looks to be okay. We're going to evaluate him a little more at halftime. But for right now, they've cleared him to go back in the game. A major force up front defensively for the California Golden Bears. Back upstairs.
You're right, Jerry. 460-pound bench pressers, their best defensive lineman. Hillary, design, quarterback draw. This has been the most effective action they've had, with Hillary doing all the damage, either running or throwing. And they look like they've settled on this, Mike.
The experienced quarterback draw. Invite the lineman up, then break it up inside. One thing about Chip Hillary in the course of an 11-game season, or if they go to a bowl game, he's going to take some hits. Because he is a running quarterback, he's an outside option, roll-off type quarterback, he's going to sustain some hits in the game.
He has 67 yards rushing and a touchdown. The only score for Kansas in this game. Play action to Douglas. Hillary throws this one up for grabs, just threw it away. Intended for Dwayne Chandler, his tight end. It was in the middle of the field, but Hillary just threw it as far as he could to get away from the pressure. Stops what? The clock with 1:32 left.
What Jerry Punch was talking about with Mac Travis. Look, number 58, just watch. As he starts to get effort, now he gets picked up. They double-team him. But he's such a force, not only getting movement up the field, but his leadership ability for this Cal defense. They need him in the game.
Hillary against the five-man rush, another quarterback draw. They get about four this time. Brought down by Michael Davis.
Every time I see a quarterback get hit, I just think of that Al Davis commercial that they have on ESPN. The quarterback must go down, and he must go down hard. Well, Chip Hillary's going to go down tonight and go down hard because Cal wants to put some hits on him. A lot of coaching philosophies, you don't like to get your quarterback hit, but Chip Hillary, like I said, Glenn Mason has so much confidence in him as a competitor.
Using an awful lot of time here, down to 54 seconds. It's third and six. Hillary will just give it off, and Chapman up to the 40. Excuse me, that's Maurice Douglas trying to get the first down, and he'll be stopped about a half yard shy. Jody Graham and Tyrone Edwards on the tackle.
Jody Graham's a nickelback, number 11. Came on the field in the third down and just made a saving tackle not to allow them the first down.
And Cal will use its second timeout to stop the clock with 40 seconds left because they'll get the ball back.
Now, if you're Kansas, you'd like to try to draw them offside to pick up the first down.
Sponsors of the Kansas Jayhawks.
Coming up at halftime, our Major League Baseball pennant race update. The halftime blitz, of course, and a look at what is going to happen with David Palmer. He has been reinstated for this weekend's game.
That'll be instant offense at Alabama.
Yeah. Now, with 40 seconds left, what did you like to do? Did you like to come after the kicker in this stage?
Well, I think they have to come after the kicker on the fourth down. But I said the other side of the coin is Kansas wants to try to draw them offside. You're going to have... Cal's only got one timeout with 40 seconds to go. Your choices are one of two, of course, to go after the kick, and that looks like they're setting up a return here. Playing a punt safe and setting the return.
Barber and
not
Edwards.
Going for the block.
Barber and Edwards back at their own 20. High clock. Dropped the ball and Pete Vang recovered.
Mike, you have three choices. One, go after the block. Two, a return. Or three, to play safe. And they chose to play safe. But Tyrone Edwards dropped the football on a major mistake for Cal.
Back up tight end Pete Vang with the recovery at the 19-yard line. And Kansas with a chance to get on the board, maybe take the lead. They'll give it off on the running play to Douglas, and the crowd really comes out of their seats after that call. And they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go.
Keith Gilbert, so one of the things about when you take over a job, you know, there's so many coaches have to get used to the players, players and the coaches, but now they're talking a little bit about maybe we should have went after the kicker, maybe we should have had a return on, but they, you know, the ball, you just don't expect the ball to be dropped.
Sure.
In that situation, by number nine, Tyrone Edwards.
And Edwards is their starting free safety.
Now what they have to take, they have to really look for is a post pattern, some kind of deep throw here by Kansas, and not allow them to get the touchdown. When you have a great kicker like Kansas has, Dan Aycloth, you almost concede 3 points at this time.
Sure.
You don't want to concede seven.
Hillary has gone over to talk to Glenn Mason, and now comes back to join his teammates in the huddle. Second and 11, the ball just inside the 20. But the time is the most important factor right now. 26 seconds to go. Kansas has two timeouts left.
I would think Cal would be in a heavy coverage and not blitz in this play.
Gay and LaPercy are the wide receivers. Hillary trying to get outside. Little throwback screen, and it's incomplete. Intended for Chandler, his tight end. Well, they sent both wideouts to the left and then tried to come back to the tight end screen for Chandler and just overthrown.
Well, they went with an unbalanced line to try to make Cal think they were going to the left side, and now here you're going to see Chip Hillary just
revolve around, throw the screen, but look at the play. Oh. The play is set up. If he catches that football, it's a waltz and a dance into the end zone.
He has three big linemen out there, and you didn't even see a white Cal jersey in that replay.
They were all playing the unbalanced line to the field.
Third down and 11. Three-man rush. Hillary floats it toward the end zone. LaCursey picked off, but I believe it's out of the end zone, and it is.
Mike, if you're Keith Gilbertson, you breathe a little easier right now. Now you'd like to see a block kick, but great coverage by Ike Booth. They played zone from the snap. They were going to make sure. Watch them back up. They were going to make sure they didn't give up the 7 points. They'll concede the three if they can get the field goal made. If they take a shot at blocking it, but they were not going to give up the touchdown.
Tremendous catch by Ike Booth. And Gilbertson breathing a little freer right now. Eichloff will come in and try from 37 into a breeze. 2-2, perfect this year. Got a tremendous leg and crushes this one through. So Cal saves the touchdown, but Kansas is able to turn the turnover into a field goal.
Story of the first half, I think, is the fact that Cal's had three turnovers, yet still leading in this football game. You have to credit the Cal defense, Artie Gigantino, of what they accomplished in that series.
And Kansas will think about that screenplay that went awry for a long, long time. That was 7 points right there. 8 seconds to go, first half. We'd like to welcome the National Hockey League back to ESPN. The season premiere, not long, October 6th. And the long-awaited debut of Eric Lindros as he leads the Philadelphia Flyers against two-time defending Stanley Cup champion Pittsburgh. And don't forget, most of the Stanley Cup playoffs on ESPN and every game of the Stanley Cup Finals. Every game.
You do hockey, man?
No, sir.
Will you be doing hockey?
No, sir. Can't skate. Doesn't help. And Edwards, who gave up the fumble on the punt, is really happy that his defense was able to hold. Cal will bring it out from a yard deep in the end zone. Lindsey Chapman, the ball loose again. 3 seconds on the clock. Cal saying they have it back, and they do. Holy cow.
Keith Gilbertson's heart's just a-beating over here on his sideline. He wants to get to the locker room.
So does Lindsey Chapman and everyone else that returns kicks for Cal.
You can see Keith Gilbertson, he just, here's the return. Let's see if we can see the ball come out. Stripped right there, ball's loose.
That was Robert Vaughn, number 38, who got the hand in there and just stripped it.
Cal dodged a bullet there. That would have been a tie football game.
Now Barr will just go down to one knee. And that is the end of the first half. Big first half for Heisman candidate Charles White. 76 yards. And Cal has a 13-10 lead. And Hillary with the only touchdown for the powerful Kansas Jayhawks. They get the touchdown here, but still trail by a field goal. That's our halftime story from Kansas. Chris Fowler is next after this.
The temperature never drops below Xerox. That's very important to remember, especially at a time like this, when it's very deserted and very cold. Ah, you did remember Xerox antifreeze. The temperature never drops below Xerox.
Hey, get comfortable. A jillion tiny air bubbles make Comfortech lightweight and super flexible. Casual look to look this dressy. Get comfortable.
I take my son to daycare every day, and his security is my primary concern.
Paul Kuehn talks about his new Goodyear AquaTread radials.
When I first saw the AquaTread, I thought, okay, I see how the water is going to flow away.
The advanced deep groove aqua channel channels water away as you drive.
I feel like I've got control in different conditions.
AquaTread, only from Goodyear. Paul Kuehn knows, and it's why we say the best tires in the world have Goodyear written all over them.
I feel very confident.
When you are making a list of the greatest achievements of this century, please consider Subway's 79-cent round sandwiches. We have taken the great taste of Subway, including our fresh-baked bread, and made it round. So it's highly portable and highly affordable with a low, low, low price of 79 cents. While this great achievement may not change your life as much as the clapper, our round sandwiches certainly do taste better, and you can get one for only 79 cents.
Introducing the round sandwiches for as low as 79 cents only at Subway.
And welcome to Halftime. Chris Fowler along with Lee Corso and Craig James. The highest scoring team in the country, Kansas, averaging 50 a game, held to just 10 in the first half. A lot of mistakes on both sides, but Cal a pretty good job of playing keep away, Lee.
Pressure, pressure. Both teams are using an 8-man front defense with a bunch of guys on the line of scrimmage and pressuring. Cal's done a terrific job of blocking the blitz. That's a plus for Cal. Kansas needs to run the option more. They need to throw the football. I think this game is so close that the coaching staff that makes the best adjustment at halftime against the other guy's pressure defense wins.
More impressions of the second half coming up a little bit later on. In the meantime, though, earlier this evening, Alabama's big play threat, David Palmer, was reinstated by Tide coach Gene Stallings. Palmer sorely missed on Alabama's first three games, serving a suspension for two drunk driving arrests. He will play against Louisiana Tech Saturday.
Well, Stallings met this morning with all of his seniors, and they unanimously agreed with Stallings that Palmer should be allowed to come back and play. Obviously, the team needs his talent. He'll give them a big emotional boost as well, and he'll be needed in this ball club.
They have lacked punch without him. All right, NFL court news. A federal judge declared four holdouts temporary free agents today in the wake of last week's ruling, which abolished Plan B. Keith Jackson of the Eagles, Cleveland's Webster Slaughter, Detroit's DJ Dozier, and New England's Garen Veris. Unrestricted free agents for 5 days. We'll see if NFL owners take advantage of that or perhaps honor some gentleman's agreement not to do that. SportsCenter will have details. Pennray scores. Oakland up 2-0 on Chicago in the sixth inning as the A's try to reduce their magic number to 2. The Twins are idle tonight. In the East, Toronto just continues to roll. 8-2 over the Orioles now in the fourth inning. Their magic number is 7. Meanwhile, second place Milwaukee is leading California 4-0 in the eighth inning. Pat Listash has an RBI single in the second inning. National League, the Pirates are on a long 6-3 over Montreal in the fifth inning. Their magic number coming in is 5. Doug Graybeck on the mound for the Pirates, and the Giants beat the Braves 4-0. Atlanta's magic number remains 5 as Jeff Brantley outduels Tom Glavine. Matt Williams had a solo home run. Stay with us at halftime. When we come back, our correspondents will mass at the line of scrimmage for, yes, required viewing for the college football fan, the halftime blitz to get you ready for Saturday's games when we continue.
Bud Dry is one beer that drinks easy like a light and has real draft taste. So why not come around to something refreshingly different? Try Bud Dry.
Selling a house is no vacation, but that's just what the Walkers got when they sold their house with our ERA office. The ERA Seller Security Plan guaranteed that if we didn't sell their house, ERA would buy it. ERA even agreed to take the risk of selling the house at a loss. When we sold it for more, the Walkers got the profit. They used the extra money to take a vacation. The ERA Seller Security Plan, just the kind of help you'd expect from a friend. Call 1-800-ERA-SOLD. ERA, first in service.
I'm a big man.
Why do so many men stick with Bic?
I'm a big man.
Because there's a Bic for every beard. Regular, sensitive, metal.
Yeah, I'm a big man.
I'm a big man.
You start it every morning. Start after start after start. When most of your oil is still down in the pan, you start metal-to-metal contact. You start engine wear. Now help stop it with the latest breakthrough from STT. New engine treatment. It bonds right to engine parts. Independent tests proved it. Just add a quart at your next oil change and help stop engine wear before you start with new STP engine treatment.
Well, after a preseason of disciplinary problems and a lot of key early season injuries, things seem to be returning to normal for a lot of teams around the country in time for Saturday's games. To get you ready for the weekend, here's the halftime blitz, starting with Steve Cyphers in the East.
Arizona goes to number one Miami. Quarterback Gino Toretta's healthy, but look for the Canes to try to get their running game in high gear for next week's game against Florida State. The Wildcats hope to be 3-0 right now, but after going 1-1-1, Coach Dick Tomey on Monday met with all of his players individually to tell them they could still have a good season. Unbeaten Boston College is home to Michigan State, who has yet to win a game. Spartan guard Brett Laurius and free safety Todd Murray are out with knee injuries. The loss of Murray means the reshuffling of a suspect secondary. That plus a good front seven of the Spartans means BC will try to run outside while quarterback Glenn Foley favors the air. Boston College fullback Darnell Campbell is back. Maryland tries to beat Penn State for the first time in 31 years. After losing a fourth quarter lead in all three of its games, the Terrapins worked on execution and fundamentals after conditioning drills early in the week. Joe Paterno won't say whether Wally Richardson or John Sackle will start at quarterback, but he planned to discuss it with President Bush, who met with the Nittany Lions on Wednesday. Bill Clinton's connection? His brother-in-law played at Penn State. Now to the Southeast Beat with Chris Mortensen.
Ole Miss at Georgia, and it's already a must-win game in the SEC for these two clubs. Now, a year ago, Eric Zeyer made his debut as a freshman starter at quarterback for Georgia against Ole Miss and led the Bulldogs to a victory. This time, look for Ole Miss to debut a freshman quarterback named Lawrence Adams. He's a true freshman. He's been sneaking in some snaps with the first unit this week in practice. For Zeyer, he's going to have to be on his toes. The new defensive coordinator for Ole Miss is Joe Lee Dunn, a.k.a. the Mad Blitzer. In the ACC, Georgia Tech at home against Clemson Saturday night right here on ESPN. Look for Clemson to pound the ball with tailbacks Rodney Blunt and Ronald Williams are averaging about 6.5 yards per carry. Also in the ACC, North Carolina State at North Carolina. Mack Brown has the Tar Heels 3-0 for the first time since 1983, but he's 0-4 against State, and they have yet to break single digits in those games. Now let's go to the Southwest Beat with Ivan Mazel.
Iowa goes to Colorado a week too late. Buffs quarterback Cordell Stewart's foot is healthy and he will start. Without him, the offense stalled at Minnesota and left the defense out there for 97 plays. Whether it's Stewart or freshman Coy Detmer, Iowa's got a problem. The Hawkeyes proved against Miami they can't handle speed. Arizona State plays at Nebraska. Sun Devils coach Bruce Snyder has named Garrick McGee his starting quarterback for the third time. After two suspensions, the redshirt freshman finally may play. Nebraska's got a huge advantage. Snyder modeled his defense after Washington's. So the Huskers will see the same scheme they saw last week, only the Sun Devils have slower players. Baylor at Texas Tech. Red Raiders' offensive line has forced quarterback Robert Hall to run for his life, and he hasn't always run fast enough. Oregon knocked him down 26 times. At least Baylor's best blitzer will look familiar. Hall and Bears linebacker Lachey Mastin were high school teammates. Now to the Midwest and Gary Danielson.
Houston at Michigan. Elvis Gerback's status is still questionable. They'll decide at game time. It won't matter. Key to the game, Houston's offensive line and how they match up with a Texas connection for the Wolves. Chris Hutchinson from Houston spearheads a Michigan defensive line with a new look. It's attack, then read, as George Madison implements his system from Texas A&M. Notre Dame-Purdue. The focus here is at quarterback. Notre Dame's Rick Meyer will surpass Joe Theismann for the career TD passing mark at 31 with his next toss. For Purdue, Matt Pike continues to start, but senior captain Eric Hunter is healthy. Look for both to play as the Boilers look for Hunter's mobility in the second half. Finally, two MAC teams that deserve some pub. Toledo will go without Kevin Meagher, their brilliant quarterback who engineered the upset versus Purdue last week, out for the left knee. Key to the game, can Toledo stop the backup tailback for Central Michigan, Brian Pruitt? He rushed for 147 last week. If he gains 100, the Chips will win. Now to the West Beat and Mel Kiper.
San Diego State at UCLA. The Aztecs have never beaten a Bruin, but remember, they've never beaten BYU at Provo until this year. Al Luganville's club had over 2 weeks to prepare for this game, but they aren't completely healthy. Starting quarterback David Lowry has not practiced since last Thursday due to a back problem. He claims he'll be ready, but if he can't go, third-year sophomore Tim Gutierrez, who's taken only 3 collegiate snaps, will get the nod. In the end, though, if Lowry's okay to start and Heisman frontrunner Marshall Faulk gets his 30 carries, the tough Bruin defense should be in for a long afternoon. Washington State takes on Fresno State. Blue chip junior quarterback Drew Bledsoe has caught 6 interceptions in the first 2 games, but he'll be attacking a Fresno State defense that lost 9 starters to graduation, including 3 in the secondary. Washington State defense gets a major boost with the return from an injury of big play defensive end Lewis Bush.
BYU at Hawaii. After getting shellacked in their last two trips to the island, the Cougars have changed their departure time. They flew out of Provo yesterday, giving them an extra day to get themselves acclimated to the time change and tropical setting. BYU quarterback John Walsh is out with a separated shoulder. Mobile lefty Steve Clemens takes over. They'll need his escape skills with 320-pound left tackle Eli Herring out 6 weeks with a knee injury. Chris?
That's our group of mad blitzers. Lee kind of liked that nickname for a coach. San Diego State and UCLA, a chance for the Aztecs to finally get the breakthrough win against a Pac-10 team and for Falk to really pull away in the Heisman with a game on network television.
They may have stopped him last year, but Marshall Falk is better himself. His offensive line is better. I expect to see him using his foot speed to spread out that UCLA defense, open up running lanes inside, and he'll find some big plays.
Craig, I think the problem with San Diego State has is the defensive backs from UCLA are the best hitters in all of the Pac-10. I expect them to come up on a line of scrimmage and make a lot of tackles on Marshall Falk.
Iowa-Colorado, important game because Nebraska and Oklahoma out of the Big Eight and possible Orange Bowl teams already have taken losses. Colorado seems like the best hope for an unbeaten team in the Orange Bowl, along with a Kansas team, but the Jayhawks are trailing. And you think Iowa could give Colorado problems?
Yeah, I think Colorado score, but I think the problem the Colorado defense is going to have is that Iowa balanced offense. I think they're going to give Colorado a lot of problems.
Pac-10 has been tough on the Big Eight so far. Michigan and Houston, the Wolverines have Gerbach, they have Tyrone Wheatley back, but you think the Cougars' defense is a lot better.
Can you imagine that the Cougars have a defense? A little late for that. They've had offenses in the past, but the Cougars have the number 9 defense against the run in the country. Last week against Illinois, they had 8 sacks against Jason Verduzco. If they can put pressure on the quarterback this week at Michigan, they'll make him scramble, and Gerbach is not 100%.
Cougar fans saying, where was the great defense when we had Klingler and Ware? What about Maryland and Penn State? It's been 30 years since the Terrapins beat the Nittany Lions. Lee, that's a long time. Who could have devised a brilliant game plan to get that win?
Well, you're not going to believe this, but in 1961, I was the offensive coordinator at Maryland. Our quarterback, Dick Shiner, threw 3 touchdown passes in the first half to Garrett Collins. We upset him 31 years ago. I was 16 then.
Does it happen again Saturday?
No, it won't happen again. It'll be another 31 years.
They need to call Corso for the game plan. They can get it done. All right, when we come back, we'll talk about more of the second half, what to expect from Cal and Kansas. It's the Bears by 3 points despite 3 turnovers, thanks to Russell White in this touchdown run.
In our program, we look at the funny side of being a coach, but in real life, a college football coach has a serious responsibility. Beyond the pressures of winning and losing games, a coach has a primary commitment to his players. The coach realizes that while you got to be ready for the next game, the real winners are those who graduate from college prepared for another field.
America wins with college football.
ESPN's College Football Saturday starts with game day at 11:30 Eastern, then Missouri, Indiana from Bloomington. The Residence Inn College Football Scoreboard comes along at 7 Eastern. Everything that happened today in college football leading into our primetime game, number 16 Clemson against Georgia Tech from Atlanta. When we come back, Mike, and Jerry will rejoin you from Lawrence, Cal, and Kansas. Enjoy the final 30 minutes.
Okay. Everybody knows U.S. Air. Not everybody knows Konica. There, now you do. Your experience with U.S. Air. U.S. Air's experience with Konica. Why you get on board with U.S. Air. Why U.S. Air is on board with Konica. So if you know this company, you should know this company. Because Konica has earned its wings from U.S. Air. Thank you for your attention.
Know what's wrong with the world today?
No one cares about doing a good job anymore.
No one cares about doing a good job anymore.
Napkin?
Thanks. Quick fix, slap it together.
Refill?
Thanks. Courtesy, efficiency, punctuality. Is that too much to ask? Nah.
Hot food and fast, friendly service guaranteed. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Finished, Mr. Martin?
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Show me a place like that, and I'd give them all my business. Why, I'd never leave.
In Lawrence, Kansas, where our halftime score, California 13, the undefeated Kansas Jayhawks 10. Welcome back to the Midwest, everybody. Mike Patrick, Mike Gottfried, along with Dr. Jerry Punch. Glad to have you with us on a Thursday night. Both of these teams came out really tight, especially Kansas, but California seemed to be able to get it going when they started going to the big guy, Sean Dawkins.
Well, Sean Dawkins is just an impressive receiver, 6'4", and he's drawing one-on-one coverage. You see the cushion he has on this pass. Kansas has to be able to try to double him a little bit, but when you pressure defense, you're going to get situations where he's in a one-on-one position, and he makes a good catch here for a big gain. Kansas offense, the key has been Chip Hillary, the quarterback, to run one option, play the outside. It's been successful, and this was a little roll boot where he just breaks contain. Michael Davis, number 32, just busted an assignment. Chip Hillary gets outside for the touchdown, so both teams, big plays.
Of course, the best running back in this ballgame is Russell White, the Heisman candidate, 76 yards in the first half. That leaves him only 9 yards shy of Chuck Muncy's record for all-purpose yards for Cal, 76 in the first half. What do you think has to happen in the second half for both these ball clubs? I thought Kansas really made a statement in the second half that they were ready to get back in the ballgame.
Well, I do, too. What I think happened, Mike, is they started out slow, but in the second half, both defenses are going to continue to pressure. So it's going to come down to which quarterback makes the right decision, stays away from turnovers, get the big wide receiver, Sean Dawkins for California, Gay for Kansas. Somebody's going to get a big play on the outside.
And turnovers were huge in the first half because Cal had three of them. Kansas did not turn the ball over. Second half kickoff in a moment.
Order your tickets today. You won't miss any of the hard-hitting action of Southwest Conference football. Hey, it's the perfect outlet.
From Red Grange to the modern grace of Olympian Tracy Corkins, the flavor and pageantry of all 21 men's and women's collegiate sports come alive at the NCAA Visitor Center. Come celebrate the magic moments in college sports at the NCAA Visitor Center, open year-round in Kansas City.
Ready to start the second half of play from Lawrence, Kansas. Cal leading the Jayhawks 13-10. The Golden Bears jumped on top 10-0 and now cling to a three-point lead. Doug Bryan will kick it away, and Charlie Bowen and George White wait at the goal line. Bowen 22, White number 2. Cal will have the win here in the third quarter. Bowen from the goal line. Flattened at the 15, and Kansas will have to start from there. Let's check in with Jerry Punch. Jerry?
Guys, at halftime, I spoke with Kansas coach Glenn Mason. He said they really have no plans of changing their defensive strategy. They said we have to do a better job with our man coverage on Sean Dawkins and continue to pressure up front. On offense, we will probably see a little more option. Option was very successful for us in the first half. On the Cal sidelines, Keith Gilbertson, the big concern there. They've got inside the 20-yard line three times, come away with one score. Got to do a better job of taking care of the ball and working the offense in the red zone. Back upstairs.
All right, Jerry, and the Cal Kansas tailbacks have done little or nothing in this game. Here's Gay on the quick out, gets up to the 24-yard line. And when you take a look at the halftime stats, especially for Kansas, as they were easily outgained with 93 yards rushing, 23 yards came from the rest of the team. Hillary got the rest. And again, the big three turnovers there, Mike.
I think the key is just what you said. Turnovers, three for California. But look at the time of possession. 18:49 for Cal. That keeps that Kansas offense on the sideline.
Kansas faces a second and two. Cousins, as they just try to work the first down, and no dice. What a shot by Travis.
Mac Travis just came across the block of the center, just made a tremendous hit there for a lost yardage play. You need his leadership in the game.
So it's now third and a yard. He had to be helped off the field in the first half. The nicked all fall, an assortment of injuries.
Bob Fellow, the defensive coordinator, going over with his defense.
Kansas has not converted a third down tonight. Hillary. They still haven't converted a first down. Booth knocked it away. The intended receiver, tight end Pete Vang. Well, they tried to cross him up that time, faked the toss, and went with a pass.
Man coverage. Watch number 45, Jared Willard, just reading the offensive play. Now comes after Hillary, makes a hit, forces the throw. Ike Booth, number 26. Pretty good coverage. A little bumping going on, but I don't think it's interference. Just got tangled up.
Iclaw to kick it away. And they've sent Sean Dawkins back to get the punt. Beautiful kick by Iclaw into the wind. Dawkins, another fumble. He's got a wedge out here if he can make the corner, but he doesn't. Stopped at the 30. 50-yard punt, return of five.
What a weapon, Dan Iclaw, number 31. Excellent field goal kicker, just punted the heck out of the ball on that play.
Weapon is right. And Dave Barr continues as the California quarterback. Kerry Klein was over warming up a moment ago. As we told you earlier, we expected to see both quarterbacks in this game for the Golden Bears, but so far it has just been Dave Barr. There's Klein, the junior. Nice hit by Kwame Lassiter, the free safety who came up to stick Dave Barr.
Dave Barr, 6'4", 200 pounds, and he's not an option quarterback. But against the Chicago Bear defense, when they have everybody packed inside, one of the checkoffs, everybody likes the option. You're going to see Kwame Lassiter, number 8, just fill the lane and make the tackle on Dave Barr.
It's a gain of 4.
Pretty good play.
Yes,
you'll take 4 yards on first down.
Not pretty, but a good play. White. Lost one. Hit in the backfield by Kyle Moore.
So much penetration by both these defenses, and just getting upfield. That's why you're having so many big running plays on draws and traps. But Russell White's having a tough time getting started. The one good run he had was when he broke the line of scrimmage.
And that was the first quarter when the Kansas defense really looked wired. Third and 7. Keep an eye on Dawkins. He's at the top of your screen. Barr looks this side, however, and throws maybe low to Caldwell. Incomplete.
That's a pass Dave Barr would like to have back because he had Caldwell again with the 8-man front in one-on-one. All he had to do is throw it. He just bounced it to him.
Last couple of times they've wanted to throw the ball, they have used Dawkins as a decoy and gone to Caldwell. And Chris Noonan comes in to punt. Matt Gay, right to this 26. Low driving kick, Gay on the hop. And got good yardage out of it, back across the 35, and a flag comes down for a late hit.
This was just a bad mental mistake by California. Matt Gay was way out of bounds when he was hit.
Dead ball, personal foul on the kicking team, 15-yard penalty. First down.
And that is the kind of momentum that Cal does not need to give to Kansas. We've got a timeout, 11:44 to go third quarter. Cal by three.
State Farm presents the rules of the game.
Today we're talking about substitution infraction. In this play, the 12th man fails to leave the field prior to the snap. What is the penalty? Today we're talking about substitution infractions. In this play, the 12th man failed to leave the field prior to the snap. A 5-yard penalty will be assessed at the end of the play.
Rules of the game has been brought to you by State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Objective when we designed our new front-wheel drive minivan was to make certain that it was the only vehicle in its class, period. Introducing Mercury Villager, the minivan that drives like a car. All this and the quality of a Mercury.
ESPN's Thursday Night CFA is brought to you by Mercury and the new Mercury Villager minivan. And by Z-Rex antifreeze coolant. The temperature never drops below Z-Rex. It's 13-10, Cal over Kansas, and Golden Bear coach Keith Gilbertson had been quoted as saying he wanted his team to play with class and not woof at the other team. He should have added, I don't want you hitting anybody 5 yards out of bounds either. Kansas takes over at its own 48. And Hillary changing the play with Cousins as the lone setback. Here goes Hillary. He'll only get a yard, maybe a yard and a half. Let's check in with Jerry Punch. Doctor?
Guys, the California defensive catalyst is no doubt Mac Travis. Now, at halftime, his right knee was evaluated. If you take a look at him on the field, you see he's got a lot of tape in that right knee. They told me they taped it to try to prevent some hyperextension. He will play only as long as pain permits. He's pretty uncomfortable at halftime, but playing awfully good, awfully well right now here early in the second half. Back up there.
Of course, we call Jerry Punch doctor because he is a medical doctor. This is a great sideline. Second and eight. Hillary, a lot of pressure. Rolls away from it. And got about five. Nice job by Hillary to avoid the pressure, and he has been the running game, period.
Well, he has, and Artie Gigantino, the defensive coordinator, with a great call here because he felt like they would roll Hillary out, and they blitzed up the field, so Chip Hillary didn't really have anything, but his foot speed was allowed him to avoid the rush. But it's important for Kansas to pick up this first down because their defense has been on the field. You saw the possession time in the first half. They've got to be able to spell their defense a little bit.
Hillary, 8 carries, 77 yards. 3 wide receivers set. Hillary on the option. Nowhere to go. Buried. Hit from behind by Scott Roseman. The defensive end closed down the play.
Well, Chip Hillary's success in the first half, they're going to put a target on him in the second half. Here comes the pressure on the option. Now they've got the pitch. They get good penetration on the quarterback, force him up inside. 3 people there to make the tackle. Scott Roseman, number 43, leads him.
And when you get the backside defensive end chasing down the quarterback, you've defensed it well. Eichloff is on to punt to the double safety, Barber and Edwards. They put Dawkins back there now, also as one of the big men. And it's a short snap. They're trying to get the first down, and boy, this will be close.
I don't think he has it, Mike. I really don't. And what happened was the last play when they punted with Cal fumbled. Cal was in a punt safe. They're in the same type of defense. It's tough to run a fake against a punt safe because everybody is looking for the fake. They had 2 people back, but they were looking for the fake. They played it well, made a good tackle. Just look at the defense. See, they're in a punt safe. They're not rushing. They're not returning. They're punt safe all the way. And they react to the snap back, and they just make the play. A good defensive surge, a good defensive call by Artie Gigantino.
Chris Powell, the up back, diving forward. He didn't get it, and Cal takes over at its own 43. That could be a huge play in this game. White moving the pile forward gets about 6.
Mike, you talk about a huge play. I think this one will come back on this one. and talk about this one as the game goes on, because that was a gamble that Glenn Mason took. The field position, you lose field position on that. But he wants to be the aggressor. And, you know, the call can work for you, but it was an aggressive call. But Cal called the right number, and now field, if they can take advantage of this field position, that would be a big play. If not, Kansas gets the ball back again.
And Kansas defense has to come back on the field, and they come back on the field a little bit too quick. That was Steve Harvey, the linebacker, who was 4 yards into the backfield when the flag went down.
Encroachment, defense, 5-yard penalty, repeat second down.
I think both teams are tight. I think Kansas is probably the tighter team, but Cal's tight too. I mean, both these teams, it looked like staff's teams. I mean, it's a big game, a Thursday night game. It's early in the season, a Pac-10, Big 8 conference. Both teams show me that they're very tight in this game, making a lot of fundamental mistakes.
Second down and a yard. And they'll go with the fullback, Zomal, who spins off a tackle, then pushed back. Second effort should have him the first down. And look at Kansas swarm.
I think they swarmed too much.
Oh, he did. There's a flag down. Check the call.
Dead ball, offsetting personal fouls each team. After the play, third down.
Oh, your split crew give a split call. Guy from Pac-10 says, what do you have? Big 8 guy says, I've got a personal foul on Cal. What do you got? I got one on you guys.
Hate offsetting penalties. Somebody obviously started it. And now they will measure for the first down as Zomal got about a yard on the carry.
To put myself in Mike Shepard's shoes for a moment, if they pick up the first down here, don't know if he feels like he can run at the length of the field against them, and he needs more than a field goal. Field goal helps it, but I think you have to think of Sean Dawkins on the post right now, or a streak route.
And they've gotten away from that.
They have Sean Dawkins. If they get the right defensive look, if they don't, they'll check out of it. But number 86 is an impressive receiver.
And he's made it a long night for Gerald McBurrows, who most of the time has had him man-to-man. This time Dawkins comes to the near side, and he's picked up by Robert Vaughn. Play action by Vaughn. Dumps it. He's got his tight end wide open. 30, 20. Stafford to the 10 to the 9. A gain of 38. There was not a soul around Steve Stafford.
That's because man coverage. Your pressure and your man coverage. You got people running with their backs to the football. Steve Stafford blocks. And then he'll come out. You see the tight end blocks. Then he releases. Now, man-man coverage. His man has lost him. But all the other defensive backs are running down the field with their back to the football. Now they have to come back. And that's when you get caught in man coverage. That type of route will end up being a big play.
Vaughn delivered the big hit at the end to knock him down at the 9. But it's first and goal. Cal. Dawkins the only wideout. Russell White. Room. To the 4. On his back, Kwame Lassiter.
Russell White continues to earn his yardage.
He's taking shots just about any time he's had the ball.
Better have a good working whirlpool at the University of California, because he's going to be in it tomorrow.
Second and goal from the 4. Again, Dawkins the only wideout. Same play, White. No call yet. No touchdown.
Well, indecision here on the officials, but I think they
sure
felt
was.
Like his knee was down. He thinks he's in. Russell White's, I scored.
Oh, I thought he was too. Let's take a look.
Little indecision, but I think they felt like his knees hit at the 1-yard line or the half yard line. Let's see as Russell White comes through. Oh.
And the ball is placed where it was when his knee went down. It looked like a good call.
I think I'd quarterback sneak here. I don't think I'd take the ball off the line of scrimmage.
Third and goal. Ball, keeper, touchdown.
I like the fact when you play an 8-man front team, even though you have Russell White back there, you don't want to take that ball 4 yards off and allow penetration. And Barr is 6'4", 200 pounds, but he ride that frame in the end zone.
This drive started when Kansas went for it on fourth down with the trick play, the snap to the upback, and did not make it. And California drove it down the field and scored.
You'll see the quarterback sneak. Just get low. You tell your quarterback sneak, stay square and get as low as you can and just ride behind the center and the offensive guard together, wedging out the defense line.
Bryan comes on to try to make it a 10-point lead and does. So the Golden Bears of California on the road at Kansas have increased their lead to 10.
Why is the new Mercury Villager the only minivan that meets all passenger car safety standards and has standard four-wheel anti-lock brakes? Good question. Introducing Mercury Villager, the minivan that drives like a car. All this and the quality of a Mercury.
The temperature never drops below Xerox. That's important to remember at a time like this, when it's very dark and very cold. Ah, you did remember Xerox antifreeze. The temperature never drops below Xerox.
Georgia Tech's Sean Jones faces a tough and determined Clemson defense. Saturday night, live on ESPN.
7:02 to go, third quarter. Cal now leads Kansas by 10. And the drive, 57 yards after the fake punt play did not work. And Barr finished it off with a one-yard run. And here is the fake punt play as they snap it to the upback. And Cal was there to stop it about a half yard short. One of the plays that you look back on during a game, say, well, that could have won it, that could have lost it. Certainly changed the momentum and a drastic change in field position.
Well, field position is the biggest change.
Bryan to kick, Bowen and White are deep. Bowen 3 yards deep and he'll keep it there. Starting at 11:30 a.m. every Saturday morning, College Game Day, Chris Fowler, Lee Corso, and Craig James will tell you what's going to happen in the afternoon. And then at 12:30, we'll go off to show you what's going to happen in Bloomington as Missouri takes on Indiana. And then at 7 o'clock, the Residence Inn scoreboard show all the scores and highlights, including that of your favorite team. And at 7:30, number 16, Clemson, goes to Georgia Tech. The Jackets trying to rebound from the thumping at Virginia.
Cal just stemmed their defensive line. First time I've seen him stem the whole group.
Hillary with a short drop and a quick out intended for McKirsty incomplete.
Kansas offense a little out of sync. And we talked about decisions by the quarterback as Coach Rule, the offensive coordinator, is on the sideline. But California moved just before the snap of the ball after Chip Hillary made his checkoff. Like to move late so that the quarterback doesn't get a second chance to come back at you with the change in the play.
Hillary has only hit 3 out of 13 for 47 yards in this game. Well, defense by Kansas. They'll go to Douglas on the run, and Douglas knocked into the backfield and then dropped. Michael Davis and Chidi Anoto make the tackle. Kansas with 148 yards in total offense. They came into this game 8th in the country.
The Cal defense is now getting some rhythm in the 8-man front. Look at the penetration. There's no place to go. Michael Davis, number 32, you can't block him because he's the 8th man.
And Mac Travis hurt again.
Now Cal needs to be thinking in ways where Chip Hillary to try to get him outside in the passing game.
Travis, if you joined us late, had to be helped off the field in the first half. He's been banged up really ever since spring practice. And he is without a doubt their best defensive lineman, one of the best in the country.
Mac Travis is the second man in from the right on your TV screen, number 58. Just really going hard inside. He penetrates inside. You can see him laying on the ground. Can't see where the injury occurred, but
Jerry Punch reported earlier, they had one of the knees taped, and it looks like he may be in trouble again. We'll be back in just a moment.
Pizza Hut delivery.
About the half-price pizzas you have. If I have one pizza at regular menu price, can I have another pizza at half price?
Half price.
So if I have a half dozen pizzas, I can have another half dozen pizzas at half price.
But that's not the half of it. Now you can have a medium pepperoni for $6.99.
$6.99?
$6.99. And any second pizza is half its regular menu price.
Wow, that's a deal and a half. Could you have them here by halftime?
Halftime?
Halftime.
Halftime.
Halftime, because I have half of mine and have half the guys in the neighborhood over here for half-price pizza for watching the second half. Of course, I have to ask my better half.
Get a medium pepperoni for $6.99, only from Pizza Hut delivery.
Nearly half a century, Martinsville Speedway has been the showcase for Fender Bender short track excitement. Don't miss a single lap as NASCAR's points battle continues at the Goodies 500, Sunday afternoon live on ESPN. Tonight on SportsCenter, the O's hope to bird dog the Jays. Some big names get some freedom in the NFL. Now the union will try to stop the draft. And we'll preview the college weekend. Keith Olbermann for Dan Patrick. Join us tonight on SportsCenter.
The entire Cal defensive unit gathered around their star, Mac Travis, who has been put in the chair, and they will have to take him to the sideline. Travis injured for about the third time in this ballgame, and you can see the frustration from the young man as he has to leave the game. Kansas facing a third and 12. Hillary changing the play. Has time. Throws deep, intended for gain. It's picked off. Wolf Barber makes the grab.
Well, there's different ways you put pressure on a quarterback. You pressure him with a four-man rush, you pressure him with a blitz, and then you play mental pressure with them. You show them a defense where you think they're in man-to-man coverage and press. Look at number 8, Wolf Barber. He lines up on the receiver. Now, this is where Chip Hillary, the quarterback, is making the check. He's already made the check. Barber drops out. Now he makes a bad decision to go deep, and Barber's sitting back for the interception. They baited him into the interception.
And the first turnover for Kansas tonight. California with great field position again. They take over at their own 38-yard line. Barr back to throw right away. Gets it out to Jeff Jones. And Jones up to the 47, maybe the 48-yard line.
Artie Gigantino and Mike Shepard, both the coordinators, have done a nice job of mixing up defenses and offenses. And I think right now with Kansas, just needs something good to happen because they rolled by such big scores in those first three games. And all of a sudden to be behind, they haven't been behind this year. They haven't been in this position. They need somebody to step forward on the field and give them the leadership they need to try to turn the tide a little bit.
They were down 10-0 in the first half, closed it to 13-10 at the half. They're down by 10 again here with 6:24 to go in the third quarter. It's 20-10, the measurement just short of a first down. Well, you can see California's confidence grow. We talked about they didn't know what kind of a team they had after Purdue beat them.
Exactly, Mike, and what you said, Dave Barr's confidence is growing. Number 16, you're seeing a quarterback develop tonight that maybe end up being one of the better ones in the Pac-10.
White behind Zumwalt in the eye. And on second and inches, they'll go to White for the first down and more. White couldn't keep his balance, got to the 45-yard line.
Now with a 10-point lead and the way they're controlling the football, they have whatever they want. They have the pass on first down, and they have Russell White on second down.
And White nearing the 100-yard mark, 95 yards on 21 carries. And he has gone past Chuck Muncy for the Cal all-time record, all-purpose yards, 4,204 all-purpose yards for Russell White. He has it here on the toss. Not able to get the corner, driven out of bounds the 41-yard line by a neck-high tackle, Kwame Lassiter.
Mike Shepard told us last night that two things. Russell White makes you practice harder, your whole team, because he practices so hard. But he also said tonight it was important to let Russell White determine the outcome of this football game. Give him the opportunity to control the game.
Now, White last year, quite a bit slower than he was as a sophomore. He had gained some weight. You think he has his speed back? It doesn't look like it.
It's tough to tell because he's being hit before he can get to the line of scrimmage.
Ball with a lot of time and overthrows. He had Marty Holly out of the backfield wide open, and he missed it.
Almost Dave Barr almost pushes this football. He's got receiver so far open. Marty Holly seems to push it a little bit, but you see him drifting to the left. He didn't really get anything on the ball. He just was drifting too much. Never came under control to throw the football.
Would have easily been a first down. Now it's third and five. And Cal has done very well on third down. Kansas has not. Barr with a short set. The out is intercepted. Picked off by Bowen. The fourth turnover for Kansas.
Now that's what Kansas needed. They needed somebody to step to the table and make a big play. Charlie Bowen was just in the right spot. Poorly thrown ball by Dave Barr. Somebody had to bust this route. As they talk one up, it looked to me like the inside receiver was supposed to be on a flat route, maybe broke it. Ball's just thrown behind him, badly thrown football. Charlie Bowen with the interception. Now, what can Kansas do with the football? They have to make, they've got to get on the scoreboard.
Bowen, his third interception of the season. Here's Hillary trying to take advantage of it. Goes out to his fullback, Cousins, who was chased down from behind by Ahanotu. The big man got out there, grabbed him around the jersey, and spun him down.
They had a little X done on the outside, and Chidi Ahanotu came to the outside, number 72, and was able to run down the fullback, Monty Cousins.
Spot the ball just outside the 41, a gain of only a yard. They've got to get Hillary outside. Or run him on the quarterback draw. Good run by Hillary down to the 31-yard line. He'll have a first down. He has been the offense, period.
He has, Mike, but they caught California in a two-deep coverage, and California was in a defense for the pass. But Kansas has not had any success at all with the tailback and fullback tonight. They have been. There's no tailback and fullback in this offense tonight. The running game is number 18, Chip Hillary.
Kansas has been tremendous all year at getting points off of turnovers. As you see, they only have three off four turnovers so far tonight. Douglas, big hole up the middle, breaks a tackle. Douglas, touchdown. The longest run of the year for Maurice Douglas, and it goes for a touchdown.
Talking about the running backs, they haven't been here all night. Maurice Douglas, 5'10", 195, breaks the big touchdown run.
Eichlaw for the point after to make it a three-point game.
Number 26, Maurice Douglas, is going to run the ball to the left, but watch the cutback that he makes. As soon as he gets through the line of scrimmage, there's the missed tackle by Tyrone Edwards. Tyrone Edwards just butted him up, but didn't wrap up to take him down. And then Maurice Douglas headed for the corner.
And it's a three-point game. Momentum shifting back and forth in this game.
Big turnover by California.
Sure was. And the 10th point that Kansas has been able to put up because of turnover. Before that run, Douglas had 9 yards on 10 carries. Charlie Bowen, the young man who's from Lawrence, Kansas, right here with his third interception of the year. And last week against Tulsa, he returned 163 yards for a touchdown. And if you grow up in Lawrence, Kansas, you know what a tough time it is to win in this program.
Well, he makes plays. Charlie Bowen, all season long in the first three games, has made plays.
Champlin in the white, weighed at the six.
You see, he hasn't given up. He has put a spark back in this Kansas football team.
Line drive kick by Eichel. And Chapman goes back into the end zone to get it. Cal will start at the 20. Let's check in with Chris Fowler. Chris?
All right, Mike. We have news tonight of a suspension for the co-leader in receptions in the Pac-10. Washington State's Philip Bobo has been suspended for one game. He won't play in the Cougars game against Fresno State. He was arrested Wednesday night for shoplifting in a supermarket up in Pullman. So yet another incident for the police blotter in what so far has been a season filled with them. Back to our ball game now in Lawrence.
All right, Chris, thanks very much. And that's certainly bad news for that school and for that young man. This makes you shake your head sometimes. Cal will now have trouble with the crowd noise. Barr runs the option. White turns the corner and has people waiting for him. Took a rip out there as he got around the corner. Robert Ball in the corner came up and stuck him.
Automatic to the Chicago Bear defense. Run the option to the weak side. Very fortunate they didn't fumble this football. Dave Barr was hit as he pitched the football to Russell White. Robert Vaughn, number 38, is going to come up and make a nice tackle on the sideline.
Gain of three, second and seven. White, nothing. Absolutely nothing. Mal Malanga had him around the knees. And since the first quarter, when Cal had so much success running between the tackles, Kansas has closed it up.
Well, they have, and you talk about key plays in the game. We talked about the fake punt, but the interception of Dave Barr has just turned this game completely around. This is a very key third down situation that they have to be able to maintain football.
Third and seven. Barr dumps it out to Chapman. Look at this. Six blue shirts. They told us earlier in the week that when Barr feels pressure, he tends to dump the ball in the flat, and they were waiting for it. Now I ask you, do you go with Klein since Barr is struggling now?
No, you stay with Dave Barr. Even though he's struggling a little bit, I think you have to stay with him.
Noonan to punt. Gay waits, has it at the 33, and gets it back near the 45-yard line. Mike Gottfried knows better than anybody how difficult it is to rebuild a program at Kansas. Starts 1-10. Now he is 3-0, a chance to go 4-0 in 1992. He has done a heck of a job here.
He really has. He's recruited well. He's recruited Detroit and Ohio well, and he's kept the kids in Kansas he needs to keep, and just done a nice job recruiting.
See if they get Hillary outside. They do. And he's got room. Midfield. Gets a great block downfield. Got to the 33-yard line. Jarrett Willard made the tackle, but I'll tell you something. Maurice Douglas threw him a heck of a block downfield.
California had some kind of stun on the outside. Chip Hill, you see number 72's in pretty good shape there. Chidihana too, but just didn't make the play. There's the good block down the field. Chip Hillary with big yardage. When he gets outside, watch the fake here. Good play action fake, but when he gets outside, he is really a dangerous running quarterback.
Hillary has gained 108 yards rushing. Russell White, the Heisman candidate, 102. Cousins, the fullback, to the 30. Let's check in with Jerry Ponce. Jerry?
Well, bad news continues to grow for California. Mac Travis sitting on the sidelines here. They brought him off the field. It is not his knee. It's his left foot. It's his left great toe. A hyperextension injury. They tried to pad it and tape it. He tried to get up and walk a minute ago. He cannot bear the pain. He is out for the night, guys. Back upstairs.
All right, Jerry. That's bad news for Cal. And that young man, a fine ball player. Second and six. Kansas already within field goal range. That could tie it. Hillary under pressure, floats it for the end zone. LaCarcy was down there, but the pass underthrown nearly picked off by Tyrone Edwards. A couple of times tonight, Hillary has just sort of floated the ball up in the general vicinity of where a receiver is going to be.
They got away with one here. Tyrone Edwards is sitting in center field. Chip Hillary's trying to throw the post pattern. This ball should have been intercepted. Just couldn't find it. He got turned. Couldn't find the football in the lights.
Third and six. Kansas trying to convert its first third down of the game. And they'll leave it up to Hillary. That ball was tipped at the line of scrimmage. It's incomplete. And here comes Iqbal. Bowers got the hand up the second time tonight. He's been able to knock a ball down. Iqbal perfect for the year. He'll hope to remain that way.
6'7", Brad Bowers gets his hands up. Number 99 on the pass rush. There's the hand, deflects the football.
Iqbal has already had field goals this year of 61 and 55. He's hit from 33 tonight. This will be from 47. And it's blocked. It will be Cal football at the Kansas 40-yard line. Ike Booth came up with the ball, but it was stuffed in the middle of the line.
And it looked like by a down lineman,
yeah,
because they got some penetration. Brad Bowers, number 99. Let's look right over the center. Let's look at the 6'7", Brad Bowers. Gets some penetration. There's that hand up again. Hit him in the arm for the punt block. Now you just tell your Michael Davis, just scoop the ball. Scoop it. It's ours anyway. Scoop it down the field.
And a lot of times when a field goal kicker is going for a long distance kick, he drives the ball a little bit lower to get more power. Draw play. White broke a tackle into the secondary down near the 30-yard line.
Like when Cal looks back at the film, they're going to look at two big plays by Brad Bowers, number 99, deflecting the third down pass and then blocking the punt.
Seconds to go. Bowers getting a breather on the sideline. Certainly deserves it after the last series. Cal leads by three. Kansas had a chance to tie and had a blocked field goal. Split backfield this time, and Ball wants to throw. Blitz got away from it. Into the end zone. Almost intercepted by McBurrows. He couldn't hold it. It was intended for Semien, overthrown, and Burrows nearly had the fourth interception against Dave Barr tonight.
Game of big plays. Dave Barr checks off. Look at the blitz. Nobody picks up the linebacker, Don Davis, number 39. He avoids the sack, then throws the football, and very fortunately got away with one there. But good play by the receiver, Damian Semien, becoming a defender. Knocking it away from number three, Gerald McBurrows.
Third and less than a yard. The fullback, second effort again by Zumwalt. He needed to reach the 30. Was actually hit near the 32 and then dove forward again. Kyle Moore was the first man on the tackle. And they'll spot it a yard short of a first down. No gain. What does Cal do? Well, I have some time to think about it. It's the end of the third quarter. It's California 20, Kansas 17, 15 minutes to go from Lawrence. Stay with us.
Rust. What it can do to the outside of your car. Weak, neglected antifreeze can do to the inside. You need the tough anti-corrosion formula of Prestone. Use fresh Prestone every year to give your radiator and cooling systems heavy-duty rust and corrosion protection. No matter what happens to the outside, Prestone protects the inside. Prestone stops the rust that stops your car.
You want good service? And R-E-S-P-E-C-T, well, Mickey D's is the place. We guarantee we'll serve you ASAP and without an attitude. And at the drive-thru, we'll double-check your order so you won't have to. We'll treat you like a VIP. Because we want you to be satisfied. But if something's wrong with our service, we'll make it right. Or your next meal's on us. Hot, fast, friendly, and double check. That's what you want. That's what you get. Guaranteed.
The world is in transition. The defining challenge of the 90s is to win the economic competition. To win the peace. We must be a military superpower, an economic superpower, and an export superpower. In this election, you'll hear two versions of how to do this. Theirs is to look inward. Ours is to look forward. Prepare our people to compete, to save and invest so we can win. Here's what I'm fighting for. Open markets for American products, lower government spending, tax relief, opportunities for small business, legal and health reform, job training, and new schools built on competition ready for the 21st century.
With its V6 engine, smooth, quiet ride, and easy front-wheel drive handling, the newest Mercury will, quite frankly, remind you of some cars you've driven before. That's what makes it so different. Introducing Mercury Villager. The minivan that drives like a car. All this and the quality of a Mercury.
Place kicker Doug Bryan won't get a chance to add to the lead. Keith Gilbertson has made his decision. He'll go for it on fourth and one. What call do you like?
I like Russell White, the ball in his hands.
He'll get the carry and the first down and more.
Ball carrier is Russell White
to the 18. On fourth and one, your Heisman candidate should get it, right?
He should get it. Fourth and one. You got confidence in your offensive line. You got number four back there. You got to put the ball in his hands.
The middle linebacker made the tackle.
Kansas has been able to get penetration, didn't get penetration on that play. Russell White picks up good yardage.
White now 123 yards on 26 carries. Domal comes back in at fullback. Dawkins has been very quiet in the second half. He's at the top of the screen. White on the screen. Still on his feet at the 10. Close to another first down.
Todd Stussy, number 75, was able to get out in front of him, and he allowed this play to develop. Little quick screen to Russell White. Number four, just going to brush block. Here's the little screen. But watch number 75. Todd Stussy just makes the block to spring Russell White up the field.
Second down, a yard from the 10. White again as they try to pound Kansas. And I don't think he made it. About a half a yard shy. They're running over Stussy and Al Kastner, the left guard over there. And Kastner, 56, a tremendous story for California. 2 years ago, he nearly lost his leg in an automobile accident. He was on a motorbike. And he said his leg was just dangling in all sorts of ways, was convinced it would have to be taken off. And now the young man back playing football. He was a defensive tackle. He switched him to offensive line. Really incredible recovery.
Big, strong lineman. I might think in terms of a quarterback sneaker to Daybar, even though I have Russell White in the backfield on third down.
Third and a half yard. White. He'll be close.
This is becoming a Russell White drive.
Yes, it is. Needed to reach the 9, and it looks like they've marked it inside. And it's a first down. First and goal. Spotted at the 8.
Now Kansas will bunch up on the run. You have to be a little cautious of the fade route to Sean Dawkins, 86.
Dawkins is the far outside receiver on the near side as they go to trips right. There's the delayed handoff to Chapman, and Chapman never had a chance. Field in the backfield with him and brought him down.
Cal went to a wide open formation. Russell White, you watched as he ran off the field, so he's not into play. So they gave a passing formation. You see the three receivers to the right. Now they're just going to run a draw. But number 35, Larry Theo, gets penetration on the blitz. Tackle for a loss.
Spotted at the 12. Second and goal from there. 12-19 to go in the ballgame. Mike Patrick, Mike Godfrey, Jerry Punch with you. Glad you could join us on a Thursday night. Here comes the blitz. Barr with time. Throw. Dawkins. Touchdown. A 12-yard touchdown pass from Dave Barr to Sean Dawkins. Certainly one of the nation's premier wide receivers.
Brought him underneath. He's the outside receiver. Man-to-man coverage.
comes inside. Now you just have to make the tackle if you're Gerald McBurrows, but he didn't make the tackle. Sean Dawkins with a good move after he catches the football. There's the catch, there's the little move, avoids the tackle, touchdown.
Four catches, 99 yards for Dawkins as Bryan adds the extra point, and Dawkins now only one touchdown reception short of the school record. 21 touchdown grabs in 18 career starts, and now Cal leads by 10.
From coast to coast, Dodge Caravan has happily served more families than any other minivan. But we've made it even better, because we've come up with an all-wheel drive Dodge Caravan. So now you not only get a vehicle loaded with safety features, including the first minivan airbag, you've got one that automatically handles just about anything the weatherman can throw at it. No shifting, no levers, no sweat. The all-wheel drive Dodge Caravan, a great way to rediscover American value.
Dr. Ponson. Now let's get those tonsils out.
Dr. Ponson.
I like the colors. Here's your baby.
Little Caesars Cheeser Cheeser. Two pizzas with extra cheese up to three toppings and free crazy bread for $8.98.
Cheeser Teaser.
From Walt Disney Pictures.
Are we ducks or what? Yeah!
This fall, America's newest dream team is hitting the ice and sharpening their skills.
That hurt!
But if this team thinks they're ever going to win, they must be dreaming.
How many fingers am I holding up?
You wouldn't know that anyway.
Emilio Estevez. The Mighty Ducks.
Sorry, we'll pay for that.
Rated PG. Parental guidance suggested. National sneak preview this Saturday and Sunday.
ESPN's Thursday Night CFA is brought to you by Dodge, a division of the Chrysler Corporation. And by Little Caesars Pizza Pizza, where you always get two great pizzas for one low price. The California offense has responded each time. Kansas has made it close. Now it's a 10-point game again. Cal 27, Kansas 17. We have 12 minutes and 7 seconds to go in the fourth quarter from Lawrence. Bowen and White wait at the goal line for the kick of Doug Bryan. Kicking against the wind. Low line drive, and he knocks it out of bounds.
Kick is out of bounds.
Let's check in with Jerry Punch. Jerry?
Guys, take a look behind me. The electrician in this manhole here just on the California sidelines working on the offensive phones for much of the third quarter, and thus far in the fourth quarter, no offensive phones to the booth upstairs. And remember, that's where Mike Shepard is stationed. He is the offensive coordinator for the California Bears. Now, Kansas has both phones working. And Mike Godfrey, there's a rule, I believe, if you notify the official that your phone isn't working, the other team has to pull their phone off, which is probably what's going to happen very soon on the Kansas sideline. Back upstairs.
Well, you're right, Doc, but they have to get word to the officials that the phones are not working. Now, Mike's still wearing his headset up there. He's talking to somebody.
Talking to the phone man.
The electrician's calling plays.
Incomplete pass intended for Douglas coming out of the backfield.
A lot of teams will take an electrician with them because they have their own set of phones and they want to hook them up. There you see the Kansas sideline. Pat Rule, the offensive coordinator, they're using their phones.
Must be a terribly frustrating thing for a coordinator sitting upstairs not to be able to get his information
down. Well, you know, what they might be doing is when, if they've got one set of phones on, then the offensive guys use the defensive guys when they have the ball.
Watered down the middle, and LaCursey can't get there.
Probably what's happening, Mike. The offensive guys, when they're using the defensive phone, now the defensive guys are using it. Whatever they did, they got in the end zone.
We've become an age of specialization, haven't we?
Right.
LaCursey was running the post, and the ball just floated long, and now it will be third and 10 for Kansas. And this offense that had been averaging 50.3 points a game has been held to 17. They'll need a big fourth quarter. Kansas 0 for 11, converting third down. Four-man rush. Hillary steps up in the pocket, throws to LaCursey. He's got the first down at the 46-yard line.
At the 46-yard line.
Well, those are the clutch plays they're going to have to make.
Nice catch by Rob LaCursey. It was against the Cal defense that brought in number 11, Jody Graham, the nickel back. Four-man rush. Watch the outside receiver, number 81, Rob LaCursey, just get open inside against man coverage against number 3, Jared Cherry.
Hillary against the four-man rush again. Throws complete to White. White struggles for extra yardage, gets down to the 48-yard line, picked up about 5. Georgia junior out of Allen, Texas, and as you mentioned before, there are not enough homegrown football players to make Kansas a power, so he's got to recruit outside the state, and he's done it.
Well, this is a good state. This is a good football-playing state in Kansas, but you need to go outside the state. You need to get all the best ones here, and then Glenn Mason has picked Detroit, Ohio, California has been his big grounds.
Second and 4. Cousins, the fullback. Got maybe a yard and a half. Stacked up by Jarrett Willard, the first man, number 45, who got there.
The dilemma Cal feels now a little bit is now with a 10-point lead, you play a little softer. You four-man rush him, play a little bit more zone coverage behind him, but you get a little passing, too.
Third call at 2. The ball spotted just outside the Cal 45. Fullback again, absolutely nothing, may have lost a yard. And now it will be 4th and maybe 3.
I think it's too early to go for it. I think Glenn Mason needs to punt here. Still 10:21 on the clock.
The punting team has not come in. They could be trying to pull them off sides and get the first down. We'll see. And they'll go for it. Hillary trying to keep the drive alive, and they do. First down. Nice catch by Maurice Douglas out of the backfield.
Gutsy call by Glenn Mason. I'll tell you, it was a good call. Went on 4th and 3 with 10 minutes to go in the game. Throws the quick out to Maurice Douglas. Chip Hillary puts a lot on this football. Nice possession catch by number 26, Maurice Douglas.
This says something to your offense, a statement from the coach, doesn't
he? He believes in Chip Hillary. I tell you, he has a great quarterback relationship with this young man.
First and 10 at the 39. Nice play action fake by Hillary. Going for the first down and has it. Got out of bounds at the 27-yard line. Hillary, even by his own admission, was in a slump most of 1991, but his coach Glenn Mason stuck with him, said he's my kind of quarterback. Cocky and a competitor. He had a broken finger on his passing hand, never used it as an excuse. And he has rushed for 120 yards tonight.
He's the key ingredient in this football team. He really is the leader of this team.
Well, we've seen that tonight. I mean, anything they have done on offense, it has been because of Hillary. And Cal's defense wants a timeout with 9:36 to go in the game. It's California 27, Kansas 17.
It's the same thing every Saturday. He puts on those old blue jeans and goes out with that old dog, and he's gone all day. He says he's gonna bring back dinner, but all he ever brings back is that old dog.
Here's to old dogs, Saturday mornings, and comfortable blue jeans. Wrangler.
Dodge Dakota with a new optional 230 horsepower Magnum V8 outpowers, outhauls, and just plain outpulls even full-size 5-liter V8s from Ford and Chevy. Unquote. Dodge, the most powerful line of trucks anywhere. Get $500 cash back on Dakota during the Dodge Dare to Compare Challenge.
Georgia Tech's Sean Jones faces a tough and determined Clemson defense. Saturday night, live on ESPN.
Kansas clinging to its chances of going 4-0 by its fingernails. They're down by 10 with 9:36 to go. They have the ball at the Cal 27-yard line. Cousins, the fullback. There's been nothing there all night long. Kansas brought incredible numbers into this ball game. 50 points a game tonight. They have only 17. They were number one in the country in scoring. They were number eight in the country in total offense. They've been held to 223 yards. It's a combination of them being tight and Cal having a good defensive ball club.
But even both of those things, they can still win this football game.
Yes, they can. Second and 10. Comes the blitz. Hillary has to duck under it and goes down at the 34. Had pressure from the outside. Brad Bowers, Barsala was also coming, and Evans.
Talked about Cal maybe getting a little passive because of the time and the 10-point lead. They fired the old blitz up on that play.
Kansas would need two scores to tie or win. They are certainly within field goal range of Eichloff right now, especially with the wind at his back. That could cut the lead to 7. But they face a 3rd and 16 here. Hillary, flanker screen. Gay has a chance to throw. There's a man wide open. Touchdown, Rodney Harris. Matt Gay is 2 for 2 throwing the football this year. 2 touchdowns. That one was 33 yards, and what a gutsy play call on 3rd and 16. Holy cow.
Matt Gay was a quarterback in high school. Paid off.
And they're out to go for 2. There is a mix-up on the team, and Hillary has to use a timeout. Now, this is also a courageous thing to do if they go ahead and try it. Because if you make it, it's great. A field goal could win it for you. If you don't make it, you trail 27-23. There's no chance for a tie. You have to get a touchdown.
I think Glenn Mason, he's made a decision. It proves to me on that 4th down call, throwing a halfback, double pass here. He's trying to bring his team to be the aggressive football team tonight, taking chances and trying to win this football game.
You have to love the offense. I mean, they've taken some great gambles tonight. Some have worked, some haven't, but they're back in the ballgame. Now, this is always a tough play, going for 2. It's not terribly successful most of the time because it's a passing down, essentially.
Well, if they go to 3 receivers to one side, you're going to get some kind of pick play where they try to pick for the inside receiver. Let's see the formation.
And they'll go to a wing formation with Gay on the left wing. Chuckett Johnson is the tailback, and he'll get the toss. Johnson wants to throw, and he's sacked. Johnson was looking for his tight end, Dwayne Chandler, but he was double covered in the end zone. So they go back to the bag of tricks again, and this time it doesn't work.
It's a halfback play. They get in a running formation to make you think it's going to be a run. There's the pitch to Chaka Johnson. He didn't really have time to set up, but Dwayne Chandler was covered. Now watch number 1 here blocking. Now he shoots to the corner. Here comes the pressure up inside, but Jarrett Willard never got a chance to get the ball up. We're going to take a look at the touchdown. Number 5, Matt Gay, a former high school quarterback, just steps back. Pass behind him. Now he sets up the whole secondary bit on this play. Wide open, number Rodney Harris, 84. Here's another look at it. Quick pass, step back. Former high school quarterback throws a nice pass to number 84, Rodney Harris. Tyrone Edwards, number 9, got caught up inside.
8:13 left, plenty of time. down by four. White and Chapman deep to take it. Chapman 7 yards deep in the end zone. Cal will start from the 20. Our CFA Thursday night series will continue next week as Chris Fowler, Lee Corso, and Craig James will preview the college football weekend games. It all starts at 7:45 Eastern with the weekend kickoff show. Then we'll be in Starkville, Mississippi, and the Florida Gators, 13th ranked this week, will meet the Bulldogs of Mississippi State. Hope you join us at 7:45 next Thursday night. Mike Patrick, Mike Gottfried, and Dr. Jerry Punch, along with our entire ESPN crew. White on the toss. Got the corner. Picks up six. You mentioned it earlier. White is earning every yard he gets tonight.
Well, he did it again. He's on a toss sweep. He has no hole, no chance to get outside. Was able to go inside, a little dip move and go outside. Here's tough. What would be a tough loss for Kansas because this kid, Charlie Bowen, just makes play after play.
Picked his third interception tonight, and he is in pain. White, by the way, 29 carries, 131 yards, and a touchdown.
Number 22, Charlie Bowen. You see his own player just rolls up on his ankle. Hassan Bailey.
Turned the ankle, maybe the knee. Bowen able to get up and needing some assistance.
He's the quarterback on this defense. He just makes play after play after play.
He's putting more and more weight on it as he goes off. I think he's going to be all right. He ought to be back in there in a couple of plays. And get him on the sideline and keep him moving. And Keith Rogers, a true freshman, will come in at that spot. It's a big series for the Kansas defense.
It really isn't for Cal's offense because you can't become conservative because you don't have this game locked up. You've got to continually put pressure on this defense.
Bowen has 8 tackles and an interception tonight. We'll have to watch and see if his teammates can do it for him, and they do. A loss of 4. Russell White gang tackled, and Kyle Moore, who has made several big plays tonight, got in there and nailed him. Hassan Bailey was also in there with him. Robert Vaughn blitzing from the corner. They just brought everybody.
Chicago Bear defense, 46. You see how they cover the 3 offensive linemen inside? Look at the penetration by Kyle Moore, 96. There's just no place to go.
Boy, he just went between 2 blockers, knocked them straight back, and then grabbed White and waited for help. 3rd and 7.
You have to be willing to throw the ball.
Kansas is going to be caught with 12 men on the field. They'll have a 1st down on that pass. It's a nice catch by Mike Caldwell. Kansas trying to get a player off. They had 12 men on the field.
Number 46, Ronnie Ward, ran over to the Cal sideline to get off the field. He has to get off on the other side. Now he gets to go home.
Boy, and this is a long run, too, after you made that mistake.
It was a late substitution. He really didn't have much of a choice to get off.
Well, no one's jawing at him, are they?
No.
Illegal participation, defense. Illegal participation.
Ronnie Ward, he was just so late, he had no place to go. Watch number 46. Look, he knows he's substituted for it. He says, I'm going to get out on the Cal side.
And he didn't even get off the field on that side. And once again, for the 2nd time in 2 weeks, this is a 15-yard penalty, and I don't understand. This is a procedure kind of penalty, isn't it, Coach?
Well, it's tough to play against 11, but it's really tough to play against 12.
But, you know, Mike, like you talk about, it was a mistake. It wasn't an effort to try to, but
to the rule back in, by the way. It falls under unsportsmanlike conduct, but nobody is really trying to take an advantage. First and 10 from the 38, and White will lose another yard. Kansas is just putting its ears back, and Dana Stubblefield shot into the backfield. Kansas is gambling that Cal is not going to throw on those early downs at all.
You're exactly right, Mike. You're right. On 1st down, they're just trying to get penetration, and they're getting their defensive linemen. They're playing the 4-3 on that play, just like Miami does with their defensive linemen. Just run them up the football field for penetration. Dana Stubblefield with a big play.
2nd and 11. Nice cutback. The waiting for him was Hassan Bailey. The linebacker did a nice job of closing it down. Got some help from Kyle Moore. It's a gain of only three.
Well, you're one short on the backside, so when you cut back, you're going to cut back to somebody who's unblocked. Hassan Bailey, number seven, was that player.
5 minutes, 40 seconds to go. Third and eight.
Russell looks like he's popping over and thinks they still have 12 on the field.
Dawkins comes to the near side. Far to throw, four-man rush. Plenty of time over the middle, complete to his tight end, Steve Stafford. Earlier, he was wide open, that time covered well, but they've got the first down past midfield. Larry Field, the middle linebacker, had to make the stop.
When you have a receiver like Sean Dawkins, sometimes you try to compensate. Watch the free safety move over to Dawkins' side. And then you see number 89, Steve Stafford, just open up and just, it's a zone option route where you just sit down in the crease and wait for the ball to be delivered by Dave Barr.
He was fired in there by Barr, too. Don Davis had a pretty good position on defense and couldn't reach in there. Back to the ground game with White trying to get the corner, spun off a tackle. Still on his feet, dives forward to the 40-yard line, close to another first down, and the clock continues to run.
Mike, that shows me something by Russell White, because it was a heady play. You want to try to run the clock, so you don't want to go out of bounds. Now watch, they run to the short side of the field. Here Russell White's heading out of bounds. He spins, goes back inside, but still manages to stay in bounds. Keep that clock running is what Russell White's trying to do.
Russell White, 33 carries, 139 yards. It is a Heisman-like night, but not a Marshall Faulk-like night. Second and a yard. They'll go to the fullback, Somal. And it will be close to a first down. They'll stop the clock with 4:08 to go. And California has done exactly what it needed to do on this drive. You run on first and second down, you throw when you have to, and you hit the passes you have to hit. Keith Gilbertson said he'd never seen anything like the Purdue game. He said, give Purdue credit. They beat us. They beat us in every area there was. And he said, but I never thought a team could do what my team did.
This is a Cal team. Now, they lost some players by graduation, but just sure whipped Clemson in the Citrus Bowl.
And the San Jose series is usually very close, and they crunch them. And it is a first down for Cal. Kansas has two timeouts left. This drive has taken more than 4 minutes off the clock, and they started at their own 20. They've gotten critical first downs to keep it alive. And a couple of more, they can go back to Berkeley, 2-1. Chapman on the toss. Hurdles the tackler down to the 30. A gain of 9.
California's putting the formation into the short side of the field to get the extra blocker against the eight-man front. And you watch them there take the fullback, Marty Holly, number 5, and move him over a little bit so that he can get to that outside backer before he gets up the field.
Time really a factor now. 3:22 and counting. Cal will use every second off that 25-second clock that it can.
Kansas is going to have to start thinking about spending their timeouts.
Second in the yard. White is back in. He'll get the carry. And just leans forward for what should be another first down.
See, that won't show up in the box score tomorrow.
Right.
That one-yard gain. But he was hit in the backfield.
He gained 3 yards after he was hit. And they'll bring the chains in from the far side to measure. Now, there's no doubt he's a quality back. And I think one of the troubles with the Heisman race is that you tend to put down the guy who you don't think is the favorite in the Heisman. Now, this young man's gained 140 yards tonight against the defense that came in ranked second best in the nation. And nothing wrong with 140 yards.
I agree, Mike. I think the Heisman race is wide open. You can't give it away the third week of the season. Marshall Faulk had a great game against BYU, but he plays UCLA this week. Something could happen in that game or the next game or the next game. It's not over for number four yet, or the other players across the country.
Of course, he passed
up. I'm not giving it away yet.
No. He passed up a chance to go pro a year ago to come back and fulfill his commitment to California. So they made a commitment to me. So I'm going to finish mine to them. It is a first down, a new series of downs. And White with room up the middle. Then stuffed as he got to the 26-yard line. Kansas, as Mike said, going to have to start working on that clock, and it looks like they will take a timeout here.
Watch the eyes of Russell White, the running back, as he looks just for the little hole. He's able to make that little cut to pick up good yardage.
Big hit by Kwame Lassiter, 175-pound defensive back, stood him straight up.
Rise and shine this weekend to ESPN Sunday Sports Day. See the bright spots of the week on Sports Weekly. Then, Dick Schaap focuses a light on major issues with the Sports Reporter. And don't forget ESPN's shining star, Sports Center, where you'll see scores, highlights, and previews. Set your alarm to start Sunday mornings with ESPN Sunday Sports Day.
Undefeated Kansas running out of chances. 2:37 to go. California with a second and eight at the Kansas 25. A tremendously impressive drive by California. 5.5 minutes off the clock. Here is White. He's got a first down and more to the 15-yard line.
Mike, your great players will make great plays. And even though he hasn't broke the long run, he is earning the yards to keep the clock moving. Toss sweep to Russell White. Good block by the fullback, but again, breaks a tackle and picks up valuable yards and keeps that clock moving.
Bowen had to make the tackle. White now, 36 carries, 154 yards. And Kansas has but one timeout left. Clock ticking away, 2:12 and counting.
And he's done that against a good running defense, a tough run defense.
And he's been a marked man with that eight-man front. Now Cal will take a timeout and stop the clock.
This is one that the sideline Keith Gilbertson just throwing his hands up, saying, what are you doing?
Yeah, he puts his hand straight up in the air and says, you got to be kidding. There's 2:07 to go in this game. We'll be back in a minute.
This is my new Dodge Caravan. Dad says it costs
under $13,800.
Mom says it's a great deal with air conditioning
at no extra charge
when you buy the Family Value Package. It's safe, too. With the driver's airbag, rear seat shoulder harnesses, you can even get available built-in child seats. Maybe that's why Caravan is the number one selling minivan in the whole wide world. Dodge Caravan, recommended by kids everywhere.
Can't someone pick up my phone? Carrie here.
You're dead, Carrie. That package you promised never got here.
This isn't Mr. Carrie. This is his secretary. Please hold.
Federal Express, I need to check on a package fast.
Keep holding, please. I hear Mr. Carrie down the hall.
Your package.
Only Federal Express can confirm delivery in seconds. Other companies can take days.
That package was delivered at 9:07, signed for by Mr. Hanson.
Oh, sorry.
That's okay.
Federal Express, our most important package is yours.
To have any sport right at your fingertips, just put this in your hand. The Casio Sports Vision Color TV. It's perfect for the sport in your life. The Casio Sports Vision Color TV. Available at Service Merchandise.
Glenn Mason and his Jayhawks running out of chances. 2:07 to go. They're down by four. Both teams have a timeout left. Fullback Zomalt will get the carry. Picks up 5, 6, dragging people. He has 7 inside the 10-yard line.
Kansas to use their final timeout. Now they just have to try to tackle the ball.
Down to 1:55. Zomal, 220, 6'2", a senior. Our Wrangler players of the game coming up momentarily. Some tough choices tonight. That young man Dawkins has had himself quite a night. Although I was surprised they got away from him so much in the second half after the tremendous success he had.
They had success running the ball in the second half,
yeah, they
which
did.
Has been impressive. And I'll tell you what, just Kansas down by four, but I'll tell you, they've showed me a lot. They're a good football team.
I think we've seen two good football teams tonight. Baseball tonight coming up, the Jays and the Orioles, as Baltimore with a last gasp trying to keep it alive. Pirates and the Expos going at it. McDowell goes after his 21st triple crown watch, almost that time.
At the horse race?
No. Gary Sheffield is having a season of seasons in San Diego. Leads the National League in batting, second in home runs and RBIs. Just a tremendous season. Kansas came in 3-0, leading the nation in scoring. Right now they're down by four, and they have to get the ball away from Cal. Cal, after being embarrassed by Purdue, trying to bounce back on the road, and they've done a great job of it tonight. White cuts it outside, cuts back, he'll lose about seven. White stopped at the 15. Kansas can no longer stop the clock.
You want some kind of play here if you're California to pitch the ball and go wide so you can take some time off the clock, run wide, and maybe you can break something on the corner. Look for the toss sweep with Russell White.
It's the fifth time White has been knocked down for a loss as Kansas has used that gambling eight-man front. Play clock is down to five. Third and eight. White on the toss, trying to get the corner, and he won't. The clock will continue to run, though.
Takes time. That play takes time to the field, so you burn some time.
Now, the clock will not be reset at 25 until they spot the ball. You'll see the official bring his arm down like that, and now the play clock will start.
Well, on the sideline, Keith Gilbertson's thinking, you know, do I run the ball on fourth down? Do I kick a field goal? I mean, there's a lot of things going through his mind.
And Brian wanted to come in, a chance to make it a 7-point lead, but there are a couple of bad things that can happen when you go for a field goal.
That's right. What he's just going to do now, he's going to run that clock, call his timeout, and then come up with a fourth down play.
And the play clock expires. That'll cost him 5 yards and stops it with 28. Or did they get the timeout?
They got the timeout.
All right.
Got the timeout.
They call the timeout with 1 second to go on the play clock. We're down to 28 on the game clock. And they'll be facing a 4th and 7. Well, the way it stands right now, if California runs a play and does not get the first down, Kansas will take over with maybe 20 seconds left to go in the game, no timeouts, and almost 90 yards to go. They need a touchdown. It's not good news for Jayhawks fans, but it is for Cal. Our Wrangler players of the game. Russell White, 150 yards on 38 carries. That's big time. One touchdown on the night. And for Kansas, he was the offense. Chip Hillary rushed for 113 yards and a touchdown pass for 74 more. As Cal did a great job at taking the rest of the offense away from Kansas. This has been a tremendous drive by Cal. 7 minutes and 45 seconds off the clock. 68 yards and 14 plays. White just goes straight ahead, hanging on to the ball. He stopped at the 8-yard line. And they stop the clock with 23 seconds to go in the game. Kansas with one last gasp. Here's where one college rule can really come into effect. Interference is a 10-yard penalty, not the length of the play.
That's right. And your defensive backs know that. But I'll tell you, these defensive backs are going to be so far back, they're yeah. going to be 20, 30 yards back guarding the goal line.
Hillary will send three wide receivers to the left side. Running a time, floats it over the middle. White makes the catch. He's out to the 34-yard line. The clock will stop as they move the chains. 15 seconds left. A gain of 25.
I'm surprised Cal's not backing their linebackers up a little further.
Kansas hoping for a miracle here. They've got to be at the line of scrimmage ready to have the ball snap.
Now they're backing them up. They'll give them the underneath thing.
Hillary just throws it as far as he can. Intercepted. Picked off at the 17-yard line by Tyrone Edwards. He did the job he was supposed to do as a center fielder. Nobody got behind him, and he played the ball.
Back your defensive backs up as far as you can. You see the linebackers loosen up. Try to make contact on those receivers so they just can't run clean down the field. Tyrone Edwards, number 9, just sits back. If you're Kansas, you're hoping for a tip ball, but there's no chance for a tip, just thrown too far.
Tyrone Edwards was a tailback as a freshman. They switched him to safety. He said he didn't like it, but was inspired by a visit from Ronnie Lott. Now he likes safety a lot.
He would have, he'd inspire everybody.
You bet. And now Cal, all they have to do is kneel down. Bard does it. And California, a touchdown underdog, has won on the road in Lawrence, Kansas, snapping the undefeated streak of the Jayhawks. Our final score, California 27, Kansas 23. For Mike Gottfried, Jerry Punch, and our entire ESPN crew, this is Mike Patrick. Good night from Lawrence, Kansas. Baseball Tonight is next.